YouTube, it's Brian Phillips, another e-bike. We know you love them, and we're gonna review this one here. This is actually the Mokwheel Basalt. This thing is feature packed. It's got a hub drive 750 watt motor, but don't let that change your mind, because I thought, oh, only 750. This thing has more pep in its step than most of the bikes that have claimed to have more. I don't know how that can be possible, folks, but it's true. Also, we have the high-vis stripe white wheel effect on each of the front and back 4-inch by 26 fat tires. Huge, huge mineral oil hydraulic brakes that are actually effective. That's something we found is tough to get on these bicycles. Charges here, actually passes straight into the battery. The battery drops out the front, very easy, and only with a key. Very, very easy application to do. Lights bright, easy adjustments on the front spoke mounted suspension. And of course we have a reasonably comfortable chair with quick adjust. Also, they have this fixture here that can be easily tipped, and it goes from 90 degrees up to 0 degrees. And you can have more of a bike, like a
mountain bike style.
Mountain bike style ride, or you can have a more relaxed ride like we set this one up here. Okay, it also comes with its own cutting board. That actually is an option, and I'm joking, it's not a cutting board. This of course is a rack to put your chainsaw on.
Yes,
and you can strap to these two sides and hold the chainsaw down. And if you need a kitten or a cat, there's wildcats too
here,
but those are also an additional option. So we thought we'd give you another shot of our property. One of the reasons that we love doing e-bikes on Brian Phillips RC, and you guys may not know this, is that despite what you may think about me, we do love being outside and being in the big outdoors, the great outdoors. And one of the biggest things that's awesome about having property is I get to mow these paths, and we love sharing that aspect of our property with you. But we know that some of you guys are going to be on road exclusively. However, a 4-inch fat tire probably is not totally necessary in that application. It does make for a better ride. And also, it just feels big and comfortable. Now, this bike is heavy, but there's finally clearance for the special bits that make the family bigger, okay? I just wanted to say that's one of the first bikes that we've had that actually had clearance where I need clearance. And where most of you 6'1" tall men will want additional clearance. So, beautiful bike, looks absolutely fantastic. Beautiful decal work and beautiful paint job. And just look at all the detailing on this. It's surprisingly light given all the features. And this thing actually wasn't a terrible build, but I am gonna say I spent almost as long on this front mud guard as we did on the rest. And also, second complaint that I'm just gonna tell you right now, which is so minor, is these really ugly mounts on the reflectors. Note, you can take those off with a screwdriver in about 2 minutes. I do like the reflector, but we've noticed that now on 2 e-bikes. So it might be a thing of the future. Let's hope they come out with something better. But I do love this bike. So far, I have made 1 sorties around the yard and down the road just to make sure I wouldn't die. Because the last time I rode an e-bike before this, which had nothing to do with an e-bike, I had a small accident and fell off and ended up in the hospital. Oops. So we are going to wear a helmet, like a smart person. But that being said, let's talk about the control instrumentation. Not the brightest instrumentation we've seen before. This is on the top setting. It is visible in light, but for that reason, when you see my ride-along video, which we are going to do as customary on our normal e-bike reviews, you may have a hard time seeing it in the sunlight on camera, but you can see it fine in person. It is definitely better in the dark. It's one of the more detailed displays. I'll just lift the drive wheel and show you how cool this is right here. Do you guys hear how eager that is? Yes, it's turning that wheel at 35, but I'm gonna tell you this right now. I am, let's just say, roughly 300 pounds, and it does not take me down the road with a headwind blowing at me and to my left. Currently 15 to 20 miles an hour. I'm only going about 30 on a downhill stroke, but it gets me there right away. We have set, admittedly, our power to 5 from 3, which we will show you in the Unbox build radio setup, which there is no radio setup, obviously. Also, there's these weird squishy things on the handles. I'm not sure I like those yet, but it's just a gel-filled pack. And you can actuate the angle of the handlebars and brakes and shifter. Shimano gearbox 7-speed. We found that sometimes that just adds unnecessary weight, but I do find that the derailleur on this unit is maybe a little bit better installed than some of the other e-bikes we've done in the past recently, and here's why. Some of the derailleurs we have don't hold mechanically to the frame as well, and we have found that there are occasionally problems with derailleurs. Even though it's the same derailleur, it's how they applied it to the bike. Remember, some of the components that these e-bikes use are all going to be aftermarket components that these Chinese manufacturers purchase. I don't think they're fakes. Oh, we're on Brian Phillips RC, so we got to check for the airplane. Check for the manned aircraft.
Oh, he's right through the trees.
Oh, that's so cool. Normally we'd be able to see, but we just happened to film through the trees today in the canopy.
He's right there. They'll see him when he goes.
Yes. Yes. It's the only YouTube channel that takes time to stop and look at airplanes. That's what we do here on Brian Phillips RC because we are dorks and we're proud of it. So anyway, this can be also adjusted and it will sit at a certain angle. So the derailleur issues that we've seen on other bikes is not an issue. This is not an issue, but we did have an issue here and I'll just show you. We had a little bit of a paint peel and we did point that out and I said, look at my amazing solution with a black marker. That is the only thing we found wrong with this bike that was straight up just wrong. And I don't know how you can make a bike like this without, and then we did have a little bit of alignment issues on this one screw. I felt like it was really hard to get it aligned. But beyond that, it actually is a really good bike. It seems high quality, maybe a little bit more high quality than what we've seen in the past. The packaging was phenomenal.
Yeah.
It was like a tank that they sent it in. It's still cardboard, double thick, felt like almost medium density fiberboard, or not fiberboard, but cardboard. And they used glue and staples, so it is kind of hard to open. You'll see that if you watch the Unbox. Also, I think I mentioned this, but you can adjust your feedback or your springiness on the suspension. Manual was fairly useless with regard to the assembly. Not unusual, but it was pretty useful on this. Okay, so the controller is the important part that really deviates drastically between models. It is a beautiful screen, by the way. It looks very nice. It's got a little bit of protection around, so if you would have an accident, it's not going to immediately destroy itself if you're lucky. Also, I left mine slightly loose so that I can change the angle. Anytime you have a glass screen or a hard plastic screen, it can cause a reflection into your eyes, so you want to be able to adjust this. And then at night, if it's too bright, it kind of is a pain to get to the brightness setting, so I would just turn it like that if it's dark, okay? Or you can go in and change from 3 down to 1. And that's gonna help drastically on that brightness because sometimes they blind you at night. Speaking of blinding, the bright light, you just click once, you click twice, click once, click twice. Very, very easy. It works very fast. You don't have to sit there and hold buttons and wait for 3 or 4 seconds. That's annoying. When I need a light, I kind of want it right now because sometimes it's dark. Also, the startup sequence is a little bit slower on this controller than what we've seen on other e-bikes, so you might have a count to 5. That can be really frustrating when you forget to turn it on or it times out and you go to start and you're expecting power but you don't have it. So just plan for that. Again, these are kind of like minor issues, but we point out minor issues. That's what we do on Brian Phillips RCs. We show you a whole package of our experience. We try to be as detailed as possible. Even if it's a minor issue to us, it may be a major issue to you. So right here, speaking of major issues, you can mount your own drink. That's very nice, but just keep in mind, because of the size of e-bikes, it's very awkward on certain bikes, okay? So that being said, and no, I'm not gonna tell you which bike I was riding when I crashed, because that was just a personal issue I must have had and made a mistake. So we don't have video of it, but I wish we did because then I could see what happened. So anyway, the cat just ran over there because that bird was calling. It was hilarious. I wish you guys could have seen it. Okay, so also while we're on the topic of accessories, this cutter board, that's our hilarious joke. It's not actually a cutter board. I'm not sure how I feel about the wood color. I know some of you guys are gonna love that. Some of you guys are probably gonna hate that. It does have a stain finish on it, and it is basically sealed. So My only concern is that it's going to stain really bad when I get a chainsaw on there. Because, like, predominantly the thing I want to carry is going to probably be a chainsaw, because I can strap it down and I can run it out here. I mean, you're not going to run the blade forward because there's a blade guard on it, but I don't want that to pop off and get slashed on my leg. So that's one of the reasons why we wanted that. It's probably not going to be super sturdy if you were to put a person on there. It says expressly not for people a million times, but I mean, you can do whatever you want when you get it yourself. Also, I did notice some heat sinks down here on both sides, which is good because that's where your controller is after all, and it will help to keep the bike from overheating. However, we've never really had a big problem with that, except for on one bike, which we did have a little bit of issues, and it wasn't so much overheating as much as it was just
the controller.
Just the controller went bad. Yeah. And the manufacturer sent another one, we put it in. It was kind of a pain to put it in, by the way. These things, when you do have problems, most of the manufacturers offer a multi-year warranty. This one comes with a two-year warranty. We actually do show that page in the Unbox, but we don't sit and read it. You can always look on the website. And if you follow the link in the description below, you'll see exactly what this thing has to offer. When you follow the link, you don't have to buy anything. You can just look at it, see what the price point is. You can see what the size ranging is. And I can tell you right now, this thing goes way up. It goes way down. And being able to articulate this forward, backward, or straight vertical makes a big difference. You cannot go back beyond straight up because this pawl is a single adjustment. You loosen this one piece, it releases, and it allows to catch different grooves here, okay? And so once you release it to the correct groove you want, you kind of settle it and the tooth bites in, and then you just tighten one screw. So cool thing is, I wish they would have made a quick release on that, but I think they were thinking it's gonna be unsafe, so they didn't wanna do that. This one is a quick release, but if that were to slip down, you're just gonna have an awkward ride until you can get to a stop. Now, also, I wanna just warn you about this bike. If you're thinking 750 watts compared to 1,000, why would I get a 750 instead of 1,000? I would think the same thing, but I'm gonna tell you, they do something with the way they apply torque or the way they apply power, because this thing is way more torquey than what I remember. And I'm not gonna be doing burnouts and simulated spinning it around on the ground. You can take anything and spin it around on the ground if you don't have any weight on it. But the truth is, this is not gonna be a motorcycle, just like any e-bike that we've ever reviewed. It's gonna be a bicycle that allows you to have some help. And this one is way faster. What the heck? Oh, sorry. I don't know if you guys wanna see cats. I apologize if you hate cats. We're dog people that have cats. So there you go. All right, so we're gonna take a ride. We'll give you a ride around here that we'll watch from third person view. We'll do a couple quick laps, then we'll show you on the runway, and then we'll show you a high speed pass from the third person perspective, and then I'll put on the chest rig and you can go for a quick ride with me and we'll take it through the forest. That's the outline. We want you guys to know what you're gonna get here on Brian Phillips RC, especially when we have crazy cats jumping all over the place, and we do have some sweat flies that are investing their lives in us right
now. They are, very much.
Which is very weird. But that being said, if you guys want to help support us, the best thing you can do is buy the stuff from the links when you do like it. Never buy anything you don't like. I would never ask you to do that. But this bike is really nice. If you're in the market for an e-bike, this thing is one of the nicest that we've seen so far. And if you want to see what we've reviewed before, then all you have to do is go over to Brian Phillips RC and you can click on the types of vehicles. And we have one that's like right on electronic, correct? Mm-hmm. So there's float planes, there's, you know, EDF jets, airliners, that sort of thing, general aviation, and then there's ride-on equipment. And that's where you're gonna find stuff like this, because we do have thousands of videos. We have thousands of videos, literally thousands. Don't put your claws in my tire, goof. Hey. Well, see, now I forgot to demonstrate that there's a horn. So, and by the way, if you press and hold different combinations of these buttons, it changes the display to do different things and enters both a functional menu and a technical menu, okay? So just be aware of that. And then before we get off to our ride, I'm gonna go ahead and take my helmet and I'll just show you. This is the Nito, X-N-I-T-O. We have a link to this. There's a power button. There's three settings, okay? And then off. The first setting, I like to ride the second setting. All three settings have a forward-facing light, okay? Since it's so bright, I'm gonna just shut it off for now. And that has a USB-C. Also, this has a USB-C. Did this one have a USB-C?
Nope.
No, it doesn't. Okay, sorry, I was thinking of another one. So then this has an adjustability here and then a chin strap that is magnetically detached. and very easily magnetically reattached. And so I'll show you how easy this is. I'm gonna put my sunglasses on. I'm gonna take my amazing, awesome InStyle visor off, give it to the camera crew. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and pop this, and I'll show you. I love this helmet. I have adopted it for my PPG. And yes, ironically enough, since I've never been hurt PPGing, except for the one time I was hurt PPGing and sprained both ankles, my head was totally fine. And that day I had a full face shield, and that helped protect my face as I smacked the ground because I had protection down here. Now you can use whatever level of protection you want, but this helmet is light. It's not the cheapest helmet you're gonna find. It's over $100. You can find the link to that, and we'll link to that what we do right on equipment, because after all, you don't want to get hit in the head and end up having a couple of days off work and spend like $2,500 at the hospital like yours truly did.
Right.
But that is part of life, and we're never scared of doing things that might put you in the hospital. We just want to make sure we minimize the chances of ending up there. And to be honest with you, when I was riding, I was doing nothing crazy, and it's just a fluke. So you guys, you got to remember, if you want to try to protect your head, that's where the danger is. But we love this helmet. We love this bike. It's been really good so far with our limited experience. And we are very glad that you guys are watching us. So camera crew might switch positions.
Yeah, I think we're going to
go and we'll just kind of go through the ranks for you with the understanding I am always riding. I changed my speeds to speeds 3 instead of speeds 5. So there was power assist levels between 0 and 5. Or between 0 and 3. I prefer 3 because I always run it up to the top setting, okay? Now, the other thing too is when you hold the brake and you depress the throttle, nothing happens. So get in the habit when you're new with an e-bike of holding the brake to prevent accidentally having it walk away from you while you're trying to get onto the bicycle, okay? Now, I would normally mount the bike like this, and I just wanna talk to you about the family jewels issues we've had. I mean, I do have a friend poking me in the back, but at least I'm not getting squished up front. So for those of you that are worried about that, I mean, it is a factor for many people. So I point that out, and I use the special lingo just so that I don't get blocked on YouTube, okay? So yes, this is a pretty good height for me. I'm comfortable on the seat. The seat is probably one of the areas where I'd like to see a little bit more robustness, but you can get a seat and put it in here because it's got a standard shaft size, and that makes for a very easy mod if you want to do something really fancy. Okay, so without further ado,
I was just gonna say that also comes in a step through style.
Yep.
So if you want that, this is an issue, the clearance.
Yep. But you're gonna get a lot of frame rigidity if you do this. And so if you're planning on doing any off-roading, I would highly suggest you go with something like this. Also, again, I'm gonna adjust this, and then I'm gonna go ahead and give throttle through the thumb or pedal for pedal assist. I like to launch with throttle, and you can also turn on a safe start where you have to pedal before it's gonna apply any sort of help. If you're in power level 0, your throttle knob, the throttle doesn't work, okay? And it is a thumb depression that you use here. Did you show that? Some of them are more light duty than others. I like this one. It feels very robust, and you can tighten this or loosen this and adjust. Okay, I'm holding my brake just so you guys know. So now if I were to let go, of course, it's gonna take off on me. You guys see how eager that is? All right, so camera crew is gonna step back, and we're gonna start this circus. Okay, so don't forget your kickstand, evidently. See, it automatically deploys it, but you have to push it all the way back. All right, so here we go, guys. Real off-road scenario from Brian Phillips RC. Not doing anything too intense, but I just want you to see that this bike, I'm just using the power. I'm not actually pedaling at all right now. And I'll give you a quick circuit. Look how fast I'm going already. That's crazy. Big brakes make for an easy slowdown. We'll take one of these circuit paths here. And we'll come down here, kind of do a little bit different circuit each time. A little bit of that bounce is making it to where I don't want it to make, which would be on my rear end. But it's not anything too crazy. You could also stand up, and you can get yourself off of the bumps if you like that. It works fine. I have no problems with that. Although my head spacing here is a little bit tight, so I have to sit for this area. And as you can see, I'll tear up here and give it a little bit of help pedaling, and then I'm going to switch down to a low gear. We'll kind of come in here just to show you the maneuverability. By the way, those branches are timed with a bunch of thorns, so it's always a good idea not to hit them. I don't say that because I hit them. I say that because I have a reason to not hit them. And most of you are going to want speed, but you want speed with control. And so just to give you an idea of like maybe going up a hill, that's a real shallow hill. Just kidding, guys. And I can shift in the process of going up the hill without having problems with my derailleur. This is another very steep hill, carrying a little bit of speed, admittedly, and absolutely no problem out of throttle on the way up the hill. Now back down the hill, holding the brakes to show you that you can really control your rate of descent. This is not a mountain. I understand it's gonna have limitations, this exact spot. But as you can see, very good, very easy to control. And right here, if I make a mistake, I go 6 feet down. On one part of our hill, we have a 30-foot fall if I make a mistake. But as you can see, skittish cats aside, it works fine. And we'll give you guys a ride on through this very terrain. But we're gonna pause and start up there and show you what it looks like on road for a few passes. Okay, so from a standstill, you can see I got my tippy toes touching on just one side. Very comfortable sit point. You don't have any issues where you feel like you're falling off the bike. But just to start, going uphill, this is upgrade, not like an extreme grade change, but I'm gaining speed. I'm at 15 miles an hour right now. And beyond, I'm at almost 20. I made it to about 18.6 on the display. And just to give you an idea of speed, hold on, there's a cat. That was about 18 miles an hour, no problems. Very easy to make turns. Noticing that my feet have plenty of clearance is what I want you to pay attention to as I make my next round. Of course, we have about a 47-foot wide approach here. Absolutely no problem turning around, but one of the best things about having fat tires is that if you go off the edge, you're not gonna like immediately lose control and die. Okay, 21 miles an hour there on the driveway. See my pedaling? Whee! That's what I was talking about. You have to pay attention to clearance, especially at the crown of a road like that. So we'll show you that again. We've had issues with other e-bikes with the mounts, okay? Because I feel like I have tons of knee room between my handlebars, but right here, this is where I'm talking about. You have a crown of a road and this pedal in a lean. Show them how steep I am. Go to the mailbox and show them, okay? You have to pay attention to stuff like this. That isn't a deal breaker for me because we've had bikes that are 100 times worse, but I just want you guys to see that. Now I'm gonna go ahead and do a high speed pass and we'll just go up and down the road a couple of times. I will lose mic. I'll call out my speed, hon, just repeat it.
Okay.
There's 18. 19.6, 20.
20. You should be able to hear him, I think. Pretty much all the way up to the corner.
20.6, still going.
20.6. He's going
1 mile an hour.
A slight hill right now.
One, braking for the stop sign.
Just have a light breeze that he's riding into.
Okay, so coming back downhill.
Okay.
We've got just a little bit of very light pedaling, barely helping it. I'm out of pedal strength. Now I'm at 23. 26. 27.9, 30.5, 31.1, 31.3, 31.5, 32.1, and it looks like we top.
So 32, that's pretty much the bottom there. So he's going to start going uphill. The flag that you can see up there is the cemetery that's just up the road from us. That's where the pavement ends, is when you get up to the cemetery.
We're sort of out of pedal strength there.
Okay, he's coming seventh back gear.
We're going about 30. Do have a headwind, going about 29.5, 28.8. Lost the downhill assistance. And we're gonna stop from 25, full on stop, losing the back end to nothing or controllable. Right from that little, right, whatever that is, the stop sign warning. You can see I locked up my back wheels. Not anti-lock brakes, but you can do that with your brain. That was a pretty good speed. I was making 32, could you hear me? Mm-hmm. 32 point something. Admittedly, the update rate can be a little bit slow on these displays, so we never mean to mislead you about speed because that's really important to people. Now, we technically have our controller set to like 61 miles an hour, So hypothetically, if you weighed like minus 100 pounds, maybe you could go faster. But I tend to think that this thing is basically going to put out about the mid 30s for most people. Now, I can tell you this too. The hill goes down, then you go back uphill. It doesn't seem like it, but there's just a little bit of an incline from the bottom groove there, if you will. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then we crest out, oh, probably just about where the driveway is, or maybe where this approach is, somewhere in the middle here. And that's why this works good for a runway, because we have basically, we're uphill both directions, no matter which direction we're going. So we come into land, it helps slow us down just a little bit. You only got a couple percentage of, couple decimal percentages from there to here in grade, but then you'll go up about maybe 2%, 2.5% up that hill. There's not very much. That being said, the speed is good. It's a comfortable ride. I do have this set up more for that like cruising, jump on and just run around town. Nothing crazy. Use this as a commuter bike to get back and forth. Maybe you got a 2 mile drive to work. You got one hill that just makes it not worthwhile if you're riding a regular bike. But I can tell you it's a comfortable ride. I do feel a little bit different on this because I have set myself up a little bit taller. And I think that's why I feel a little bit more in my bum. Normally I would lean my body forward a little bit more. And that would be similar to the other bikes that we've had in the past, or not just e-bikes, by the way, but most bikes, because I would tend to ride more of a mountain bike style. Mm-hmm. And so to have the fat tires and to have that comfortable sit is really cool. And I can definitely tell you this, this thing, and just to give you an idea of how much traffic we have on this road, we're filming in the middle of the road just because we feel like it, okay? Yeah,
it's the middle
There's
of
never anybody out here. So that's why we like it here. And it turns to gravel up there. We could show you gravel in my ride on, but I'm not gonna do a lot of it. I'll just turn around quick. But I think the bike looks beautiful. It's got a like really cool looking chain, which I don't know if you guys paid attention, but the chain has got that galvanized look to it. I don't know if it's stainless steel or if it's galvanized, but a lot of times the chains are black, okay? This chain stands out because it's almost a design feature. So at the end of the day, do I love this bike? Do I hate it? Do I think it's the best thing since sliced bread? I would say that it's probably, oh, and by the way, there is an inverter plug right here that allows you to charge this with a solar system if you want. It's optional. We did not get that. Why did we not get that, camera crew?
Because this is our first review with them.
Oh, well, we're going to do that again. But also the bike can, the battery can be taken out and plugged into a solar panel. So if you're camping, you can plug that in and charge it without using your generator on your camper. And it's really nice that you can do that, because if you buy one and you want to do that off-grid sort of setup, get two batteries. They're expensive. Just keep that in mind. But if you had two batteries, you could actually have your inverter plugged in and charge the bike without even taking that out. And then you could have another solar charger sitting over here and charging your backup. So you get done with a long run and you want to just go straight back to it, guys. They have thought of so much stuff that has been missed on other bikes. And the only thing they haven't thought of is let's come up with a name that isn't literally Mokwheel, which to me sounds like fake something. So I don't think there's anything fake about this product. I think it's very good. Make sure you get the mud flaps if you wanna do off-road. I hate putting them on, but like the mud guards and the mud flaps make the bike look nice. And it also helps keep you from looking like a complete dork. I mean, you'll look like me because I've got one. So hopefully that's not a deal breaker for you. But I definitely do like the bike. I think it's gonna be a good ride for whoever gets it. Keep in mind, e-bikes are very heavy, and you may or may not be. This thing has a 400 pound capacity. If you get a light on-road racing bike that costs you $15,000 and it weighs like 14 pounds, good for you. Most people can't afford that. This thing's still expensive. It's not anywhere near that, but it weighs probably close to what, like 80 something? Mm-hmm, it's a lot. All the e-bikes are heavy, okay? So just remember that when you get your rack for your RV or for your car or for your truck. This thing does not break down very easy compared to other offerings. But if you do have to break down the handlebar, you can loosen this and go this way. I would not recommend loosening the handlebars, even though you could actually take this whole assembly off with one, two, and then eventually there's a third screw, but you have to lower this down to get to it. Okay, so just in terms of breakdown, it's probably not gonna be a bike that you break down. This is probably gonna be the type where you have to, oh my goodness, and then put it up onto one of those, you know, fixtures on the back of your car or your truck or whatever, or put it into the back of the truck.
Yep.
Also, I wanted to say this thing tips over better than others in that you can lay it down without it completely self-destroying. because we've noticed that some of these bikes, when you lay them down, particularly the throttle, will get in a position where it likes to crush itself. And they're made of plastic, and they do. So just be aware of that. This one's a better designed bike than we've seen from a few other manufacturers. And they're using all the same components, really, guys. It's just the frame and the battery that change on these e-bikes. The controller itself, a lot of that stuff ends up being the same. So very impressed. And also, I felt like the technical menu was very easy. There wasn't a bunch of BS weird parameter numbers that you don't know what they mean. It's all spelled out. And that is at the end of our Unbox build radio setup. And by the way, if you're still watching, you're interested in this bike, buy it from the link. You'll help support our channel and you'll help support Brian Phillips RC. By the way, this comes off just as easy as it goes on. A lot of times people don't like wearing helmets because they're a pain in the butt. And I gotta say, even though I'm sweating a little bit because I'm out of shape and it's hot, okay, this helmet is actually about as good as it gets, second to maybe just a regular hat, which really leaves you exposed, especially since you wear a hat like this Brian Phillips RC that doesn't even have a top on it. At least you could wear a top so that you can have something to protect your beautiful hair. I had somebody the other day said that I wear my hair to look thinner. And I was like, okay, whatever, dude. It's like, well, I just get double cheeseburgers to look thinner. Wait.
You've worn your hair like that for like 20 plus years.
20 plus so years back when I wasn't this way. But guys, I'm just going to tell you this. This is a really nice bike. I think you're going to like it. I think it's going to be a high quality thing that you're going to get and you're going to be happy with. But as with anything, everybody has their taste. You may not want to sit up like this. In that case, adjust this forward. You get more of that ride. You can adjust all the handles, everything adjust on here to pivot where you're comfortable. And then you can ride this chair much higher. So you can get more of that, you know, off-road feel where you lean forward. I'm not a huge fan of that, especially as I get older. Maybe as a kid, I would have been like, I want to lean forward more. But that's just a preference thing. And boy, that looks so good over here. The sun is hitting it perfect. So guys, we really appreciate you watching these e-bike reviews. We're going to do a quick ride on. And after that, we'll have the Unbox build radio set up. It's kind of a longer one. You can skip ahead, skip back, whatever you want to do. But there is an Easter egg. And it involves trees and a guy named Esteban. So.
Sorry, Esteban.
Yes, yes. But it's going to be awesome, and I hope you guys watch it. If there was a video you would just leave on so you can see an Easter egg, this might be it. I don't know how good that footage was. Was it good?
I haven't even watched it.
You'll be able to laugh at me and Esteban.
No matter what.
Yeah. So it's going to be good. So stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, we're going to go ahead and give you a ride on real quick, and hopefully the sun isn't so bright that you can't see the speedometer. But I can tell you this. This thing gives you power where you need it, and that is out of the hole. Okay? It's not a Ferrari. It's not going to go 100 miles an hour, but I'll tell you what, the eagerness is what I need because I'm a big guy and I need help out of the hole. That's where I want power on an e-bike, and it does a great job. If you want to go up an obstruction and you've got a lot of grade, you want the power out of the hole, okay? You don't necessarily need to go 400 miles an hour, and truthfully, this thing is not geared to go much faster than about 20-something miles per hour in pedaling mode anyway. So just keep that in mind. You got throttle to get you well beyond it, but you're going to be pedaling in vain because there is no action at that point. And so for that reason, if I had to point out one technical conflict with this model, my suggestion would be to a company like Mokwheel, just put a one-speed gearbox in there. If you're marketing the e-bike individual, that might work better. Because if I can go 32 or 33, I'm going to go 32 or 33, but many people that ride bicycles that are like half my size or in shape and stuff, they're going to want to ride. And speaking of never having traction, now we do. So guys, that's it. We'll do our ride on next. Thanks for being a part of this. Coming right now. Stay tuned. Ooh, that's a nice cutting board you got there. Ooh, a cat. Amazing. Ooh, the camera crew. Sorry. She always loves it when I do that. As you can see, we've got the instrument cluster. And we're going to try for an angle test here. Okay, so we're in seventh gear, so I'll just use the thumb throttle. Got to get your hands on the brakes with these e-bikes. Make sure you can slow it down because it's kind of crazy sometimes. All right, so we're going to take the... I might want to get my butt off of the seat a little bit there. Just kind of sticking my right leg down, push me up. It looks pretty good. Nice transition onto the driveway, and then we'll come back in for a stop here. Cat and camera crew. Okay, we're gonna test that video and see how that worked out. Okay, so we're just going to continue. It says recording through the auxiliary mic, camera crew.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so here goes nothing, guys. We already took you around the house, so we'll do a little bit something different here. We'll go up and down the road first, getting into the throttle hard. You will not be able to see the screen. It's just too bright. So we're going about 18, a little bit faster. We're going about 22, heavy braking just to get this turn right. Okay, and here we go. I'll just call it out, guys. You can trust me. I'm not going to lie to you about speed. Going about 22, going about 24. Pedaling is ineffective now, so I stopped pedaling, going about 26.6. Hopefully the mic will pick up with the reasonably high level of wind, 28.3, and it's slowed down to about 24.7, and we'll just kick it into the cemetery here and be kind of respectful in case somebody's out here. Nobody's out here, just the resting souls. All right, so now we go about 25, got a little bit of grade here, about 27.6, about 29, about 32.1 was the max. Now I'm heavier in the brakes, not totally heavy, but heavy enough because I don't want to end up in the cemetery. And here we go, guys. So we're going around and we're gaining speed uphill. I am going to pedal to assist. I'm going to put it down to a little bit lower gear. And we're gaining speed, but I am helping just a little bit, about 20, about 21. About 21.7, it seems to be comfortable there. I'm gonna go up to the highest gear. We got 21.8, and the pedals are ineffective at this point, so I'm gonna just neutralize them for this turn. And when I mean neutralize, I mean halfway. And as we go, we're speed up. I'll try to kind of point this down. I doubt you'll see it, but the sun is kind of behind the screen. Okay, just going downhill. We're getting up to about 26.5. We're at 28.7. 30.4, about 31.1. 30.7, so the max speed on that pass was about 31. We'll carry it to the flat. We do have a wind at a gradient, let's just call it, like from the left to right, it's almost 90 degrees, maybe 80 degrees. So it's a little bit of a crosswind. And just as you can see, holding down the throttle here all the way, that's what we do. And we slowed down to about 24 miles an hour with the understanding that it did come out of the throttle. We'll come up to the stop sign. And we've got another off-road vehicle going by. Got neighbors. And so as you can see out here, that's what we do. All right, great. So we're just gonna get into the throttle hard. And yes, there's evidently a windy road coming. I don't know where it is though. A little bit of bounce as you kind of come out of the resistance of the pedals. Going 31.1, hard braking, and we'll make a sharp turn and we'll take a left into the yard. Boom, got a little bump. There's the transformer that was very expensive. And we'll go around our windsock, and there is a dip there because of our water meter. They had to displace that. Now I noticed a little bit of translating. I'm going about 17 miles an hour, a little bit of translation of the vibration into the booty, which is not necessarily great. Underneath this gorgeous huge oak tree in the shade. And continuing, this is a steep hill. I'm gonna get into my lowest gear just in case I have to help, which I'm currently out of speed to help because of the gear ratio. This is a very steep technical spot of the yard. As you can see, got down to 8 miles an hour, did not bottom out. That is awesome. We have not seen that before. And we'll just take a little bit of a different route over the septic tank right here. And there's our backyard. As you can see, we're gonna do some light braking as we go descend this hill at about 6.2 miles an hour. Nice, easy transition. We could take a right-hand turn there, but we usually speed this direction. Going about 10, a little bit of a bump downhill. That's a 30-foot drop. If I make a mistake, I don't want to do that. Okay, going up the hill. Do have a helmet on, just so you know, in case I would hit this tree right here. That would really suck. And then we're to the perimeter of our edge of our lot. And then we're just right up this hill. Now remember, we started with less speed carried. I am pedaling in the lowest range, and I'm at about 11, down to 8. Let's see if it bottoms out. It hasn't bottomed out. This is amazing. We're still at 5 miles an hour, enough to keep our feet on the pedals, and we made it through. That's amazing. Amazing, guys. Next to our garden here, we're gonna take a different path this time, going up onto the runway, as you can see. We're gonna go this way around the house. This is one of the routes we really enjoy. Kind of stay inside this pose until the last second. As you can see, it gets really steep. Don't want to hit those stakes for the tree. Then we'll go around this direction. Got a little bit of a bump here. Standing up takes the ride with stride. And then up the hill we go onto the sidewalk. That is a very steep approach. We're gonna take a different route this time. Get to the middle gear, helping it along, but we are not gonna go up full speed down this hill because I don't wanna die. Heavy braking about 11 on the transition down the hill. We're gonna go to the right. Watch out for the June bug trap, which works really dang good. Thousands of them in days. We're gonna go between these two trees to just show it can be done. We'll give you two routes like this, similar to what we showed earlier. The difference is you're riding with me, so you get to see just how things bounce around. This is kind of where the pond's gonna go, guys, if we get it. Okay, switching to the lowest possible gear for some technical turns here. As you can see, the handlebars are not super wide. Taking it very slow. Deceivingly challenging spot into the throttle. Let's see how it does. Does good. Okay, good job, me. I survived. And then out and into the wilderness. All right, this is the 30-foot fall. If you guys don't believe me, I'm gonna stop and just show you. I don't think you guys can see. We'll just stop, get off. We don't usually get off on our rides, but I'm gonna take the camera on my chest rig and just point it down there. Kind of hard to tell, but if I pinch to zoom, yeah, it's kind of hard to tell, but it's way down there, guys. And this is kind of where the dam is gonna reach across. So as you can see, we're in the middle of our tree line here. Okay, getting back on the bike. Sorry for the little, that's not the Easter egg, guys, don't worry. There's better than that coming. Okay, into the throttle hard and pedaling from first gear. That's the first bridge we built over there. And here we go, guys, we'll try this again. Got a couple of small oak trees there if you see the cutouts. We're gonna go up and all the way around. And we're gonna take the speedier path here, take us to the right. Okay, so you'll notice the steep angle and no problem at all for this bicycle with the tread pattern going all the way around the 4-inch tires. Taking a left here, we'll continue up. This is the path we started on. Not sure if you guys can tell where we are, but there's the windsock. And just so you guys know, this is the front, let's call it 3 acres, 3.5 acres of our property. We have 23 acres. So we'd like to open up some more paths. We're gonna go on this other side in front of the water meter pit and just show you a cool line that we can take. We don't generally take this line, but if we want to, we can, okay? This takes us down where we've done some different types of filming. And I just realized I can't quite fit. As you can see, these trees are just a little bit too low. Don't wanna risk it and get whacked off on the head. Okay, so we'll double back around here. We're probably just about out of our path, but as you can see, there's a million different ways to enjoy this bicycle. You can pedal assist and stay out of the throttle, or you can ride it like you stole it if you want. It just depends on your taste, guys. Let's show you a pretty extreme hill here. Look at all those June bugs. That's crazy. Okay, off the seat and up the hill. Nice smooth transition, lots of power to get you there. But definitely not a dirt bike, guys. These things don't have internal combustion engines to push you at 100 miles an hour, but they will get you moving and they will get the heart pumping, even though you're not pedaling as hard as you would otherwise be. And I can tell you this right now, this bike, it really, really does a nice job. It kind of does it all. It's comfortable, it's good looking. It's definitely worth considering if you're considering an e-bike. We're gonna take one more stories around the house here. Heavy braking around that turn. This is one of my favorite spots where I'm really riding hard because I can catch air and the suspension just really, really does the trick, guys. Little bit of belt slapping noise from our chain slapping. There's the camera crew hanging out with a cat. All right, we're done. Guys, that's what you get. This thing is super nice from Mokwheel. As you can see, it is a beauty. It holds its own in every way that we've ever measured. Also, there is a brake light. We didn't talk about that much. We didn't talk about the headlights much. No dark content. What are you doing, cat? So if you decide to get one, I think you'll be thoroughly satisfied. What do you think, camera crew?
It looks really cool. It looks comfortable.
There is one thing I noticed in that ride, and that was my right hand was getting a little bit numb because of the position, the exact position. So I might need to adjust this a little bit. Mm-hmm. And I think it might have something to do with that handle thing. But guys, that's all you get for now. We're going to transition into our Unbox build and radio setup next, which again, there's no radio setup. And this is definitely a winner. So if you guys are in the market, check the links in the video description below. You can learn more about pricing. You can learn more about how to support us by following us on YouTube. If you click the bell for notifications when subscribing, you'll see all our new content. And I would highly encourage you to do that. But if you're looking for something in particular, you can go over to brianphillipsrc.com. And we also have links to Patreon, PayPal, YouTube members, and YouTube super thanks are always welcome. Either way you choose to support us, we appreciate any of them. And if you choose not to support us, that's fine too, because we know everybody's in different circumstances. But smash the like button if you enjoyed the video or at least part of the footage. And just don't vote on the product that we're reviewing with the thumbs up, thumbs down, because that makes it really hard on us, because we do not control how good or bad they are. And the value we try to bring has more to do with whether or not the product is worth considering in a serious manner. And that's what we try to do our best on Brian Phillips RC. And we hope you guys can see that through our hard efforts. All right, guys, Unbox next. Thanks for watching. YouTube, I have gloves on, and you know what that means. The box is too big, so it's here. Please forgive us. That's right.
Again.
You saw it first here on Brian Phillips RC. We're gonna open this amazing e-bike. If you don't know what an e-bike is, it's an electric bike. And what we do is we unbox them, we set them up, and then we show you all the challenges we faced, and hopefully we don't run into any components that are actually broken. I must say, one of the nicest looking boxes we've ever gotten from an e-bike.
Definitely.
It doesn't have any damage on it. There's no parts hanging out the side. There's no like blood stains on it.
All good signs.
All good signs. So we're gonna keep working at this. We're gonna show you what we do. I am providing my own needle nose pliers. That is the easiest way I've found to open these staples. I open staples like this all the time at work. And there is an easier way, and that is to have a bigger, more robust pair of pliers. You can also cut them if you want to and then pull them out one half at a time if this is too hard for you, okay? My suggestion is remove as many staples as you can get away with. Don't cut with a box knife unless you have to, because sometimes, regrettably, you do have to actually send these things back when there's problems. And that's why most every one of these boxes is gonna say something like, keep, oh wait, is this a lid?
This one doesn't.
This one doesn't. You know what? I wonder if, no, this one still opens. It's just glued in the middle, which, to be honest with you, China, if you're listening, China. Glue is good for holding boxes together, but it's not necessarily good for opening them.
Jeez.
Good lordy lord. Hey, we were just talking about how well this was packed.
Yep.
So beggars can't be choosers, which is another way of saying you get what you get from China. China. All right, so I've used a utility knife. Oh, good lord.
Is that glued too?
Yes, it is.
Well, there's a reason it made it here, I guess.
There's a reason it's in good shape. And I gotta say, I am sort of annoyed with this, but we just got done with another bike. Except we didn't. That was broken.
And it was not glued.
And it was not glued. And it had a giant hole in the box.
Yeah.
And we were like, uh-oh, there were squirrels that got out. We found a screw on the floor and a nut and all sorts of stuff. So it's a real deal. What? There's wood on it? What is this, a cutting board?
It has a writing thing that is not for people.
Yeah, we would never ever put people on that. Okay, I'm just gonna pull the box because a box is, oh, accessories, take me.
Jesus, labeled.
Okay, well, maybe they could take a little bit of their box management skills and apply it to this. Ooh, we have a whole utility set here. Nine standard? What? No, they're not standard. What are they talking about?
No, they're standard metric measurements.
Standard flathead hex wrench?
What?
Yeah, I agree. What? What's that in there for? Whatever. Okay, I'm just gonna, what do they mean? Size?
Make sure to wear the face mask and be sure to use it in a safe place.
So you'll see me in a face mask today for sure. Okay,
do not join striking the group, and beating.
Win gifts, okay. Ooh, a manual, that's fancy. That's a pretty looking, but that's not the bike we're doing.
Yes.
What? Sure. Oh, they just give you the cutting board attachment in case you want to cook on it?
It's like an extra add-on.
Oh, thingy. Okay. We have some nut caps. Lots of bolts and stuff. That's always my favorite thing to see. Haha. Oh, we have another blower. Yep, you use this. You can inflate your tires if you would like to. It actually feels nicer than the one we got last time from another bike manufacturer. Really? You're gonna start it like that? Okay, I'm not gonna.
It's 4.5 minutes.
You know, whatever. I'm not gonna put the sleeve on there. All right, so we have, looks like left and right pedals look pretty standard. We're gonna tighten those from the inside. And they do have reflectors on front and back, so that's good. We'll go ahead and cut these. I have mentioned this in other bike videos. It feels just like today when I did it. If you just unpack each item as you touch it, you will eventually stop touching new items and you will be done and you'll be like, thank God, it finally came to an end. That Hopefully. Is the build. I mean, or not, or they're just like keep delivering boxes, which could happen.
Yep.
Okay, that looks to be a headlight and it's solar powered. Just kidding. Like, guys, seriously, I'm just joking.
Like ET.
We have solar system on our roof. This is not a solar panel, it's a reflector, but it would be hilarious if that was a solar panel. That'd be something China would do. Good Lord, these are really nice. 18. They get right to the point. They don't mess around with no branding. 18.
No.
Chrome vanadium. Okay, so we got vanadium, chrome, 15 and 18. Okay. These aren't combination sizes, and look at this. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Now I can make extra leverage if I want. And I love that. Okay, amazing. Okay, nice tools actually. We have a lot of those now. Okay,
so
two zip ties. Don't give them more or you're fired. Two.
Those zip ties, they really put you over the top.
There's a gift card too. It says join the group and win free gifts. I don't think that's the way gift cards work, China. It's like when it's a gift card, that means like, hey, take this to Starbucks and you get like a free coffee.
Yeah.
And then, like, there's a little extra money left on it. That did not go the way I wanted it to. I was trying to throw it that way. Okay, this must be the charger. US 54.6. So it's 54.6 volts at 3 amps. Okay, we've seen this before. It's similar to what we've seen. Oh, user manual. Lithium ion battery charger. Ooh, fancy. I'm going to read that. Seriously though, the most dangerous part of this entire apparatus is the battery, so just be aware if you're charging in stupid ways, you're increasing the risk, you know, to your home and stuff.
With bikes.
So, with bikes.
Is that really still the most dangerous part?
I mean, probably.
Like falling off on your bed is
there's
not the most
that
dangerous part.
Detail. Sorry, my memory's not serving me well since I hit my head on the concrete. Okay, so this charger looks nice. It's heavy, that's good. When they're heavy, and then if you look on here, it says the output 54.6 volts at 3 amps. That's DC, little dashy line. This is 100 to 240 volts at 2.5 amps max. Okay. Seems like just an hour ago that I read the same thing. Okay, so we're just going to untie this and show you how long this is. And one thing you're going to find is that they come with stickies so that they don't slide. Make sure the stickies are down, okay? Because the heat sink is up usually. And I could be wrong about that, but I'm just making basic assessments from like life experience. Okay, we're gonna stick this into the hole. This thing is hot from being outside, feel it.
Yeah.
Isn't that crazy?
It's like 100 degrees.
Drum connector, AC input. Okay, this comes from the wall. And then look at this. This has a polarity, does it? Yeah, the plus is on the inside, the minus is on the outside. If it's a drum style, they have several styles.
That's okay. What those diagrams are for?
Yeah.
Oh, I learned something today.
You haven't learned that yet from me? I'm throwing that away. Sorry. Okay, then we have a bag. It's little. I don't know what's in it. Maybe it's some good stuff. Ha ha ha. No, it's just nuts.
More nuts.
That's a lot of screws. Good Lord. Oh my goodness. Wow.
Maybe don't,
holy
maybe
cow.
Don't confuse the screw sacks.
No, I'm going to screw them. Oh, those are brake pads. Yes, we have from brake pads. Awesome. Okay, hopefully the brakes are good. We have some nut caps. That's always nice. Lots of screws. I'm gonna keep this and I'm gonna throw that away because this is a really high quality apparatus for storage needs.
Bag of bags.
I can put my gift card in there and we can re-gift that to somebody at Christmas because it's a gift card, obviously. Okay, so now normally when we open these boxes, it's kind of a fiasco because like we don't know where to open them. I'm just gonna, you know, I feel like it was just a few hours ago, and so I'm gonna go ahead and just take this knife blade, expand it. And I'm gonna cut like this. See how I open this up? This thing is like wood. Look at that cardboard. It's like wood.
Oh, now we are gonna have to keep the cardboard too, aren't we?
Well, I mean, you could do some nice stuff with it. Okay, so you see how I'm doing this? I'm holding this and the penetration as a blade is barely making it, okay? These are double thick, corrugated cardboard, very strong. And what I'm doing is I'm working down just a little bit at a time. So I don't like slash the tire or cut some wire or some stupid thing like that, okay? Now now that I can see in the side of the box, I'm gonna just carry the blade up to my cut point. Okay, show the people. Ooh, white wall tires. Whoa, those are reflective tires. Did you know that?
Reflective?
They're reflective. It's gonna be like, wow, I see that guy right before. That's
great.
I know who's gonna do it too. Sorry, inside joke. I can't say that, we might get sued. All right, so you see this? Amazing. I'm not left-handed, so let's see if I can do it left-handed. Kinda. It's harder. You know who's gonna do it, hon? Might be the guy that has the red balls that he throws in our ditch.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
That's who. He's probably watching this. Oh, I would never do that. Give me another Red Bull. Not Red Bull. What was I trying to say?
I'm sure that's exactly what he was saying.
Okay.
We're not nearly enough beeps in that sentence. Ta-da!
See? High-vis tires. Amazing. Okay, so let's stop for a moment because this is going to be such a short video. I'm going to take some chairs and put them behind this thing. Then when that falls, it will fall into a chair.
Okay.
Gosh, it's like the subfloor so much stronger now that we have this box on it. Our house is finally finished.
Great.
Okay, so let's talk about this. How do you open a box like that? Is that a problem? Not really, but you do need a lot of space to do it. And also, I can tell you from personal experience now, suppose you get halfway through this build and say there's like some gigantic, miserable failure right in the middle of it. You can fold it back shut and you can tape it shut. And you just tape, 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 until it's held together. And then you like push it out your door and it goes just like UPS.
Yep.
Or FedEx. In our case, FedEx. Actually, our FedEx does pretty good.
Yeah.
So I have tape for that just in case. We hope we don't have to use it. All right. So you see a bunch of zip ties on here. So that's what side cutters are for. These are side cutters. Some people call them other things. I don't know if I can use that word on YouTube. This is a utility knife.
We'll go with side cutters.
I have a crescent wrench. These are my provided tools to myself from Brian Phillips RC to myself. Okay, so I have those tools that are going to supplement these tools. The only reason that I have those tools is because then I can use this to add additional leverage to that. However, in this case, we might not need this because we actually have an open end and an open end. So you can use this to tighten, and then you can get in here, and believe it or not, you can usually, depending on the angle, you can sometimes get a little extra leverage, and that's very handy. It's like a tuning fork. Okay, so we're gonna start cutting things. This is a wheel, and it's got, oh yeah, mud flaps. Those are my favorite. These are seriously high-vis. Like, that's kind of cool, actually. Do you see that? On both sides.
Oh, it is. Okay, I caught it in the light that time. I don't know if it's going to catch on camera, but I see what you're talking about now.
Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't see it immediately, because that was like the first thing I saw. And, you know, I think what you're trying to do is you're just trying to set it up so that, you know, like the court. What? Look at these reflectors. They've got the ugly ones on this one, too.
Yeah, what? Why?
Why did they switch to these ugly, stupid clip-on style?
Yeah, those
you know are... why? Because the other ones are falling off too much.
They are.
Good Lord, that's a long zip tie. These are pretty good zip ties still.
Oh, good.
If you guys are extreme cheapskates like me, and you just want to have extra zip ties to maybe package your bike back up, just in case it happens.
China, please stop sending us nice zip ties.
These zip ties are so good.
Sincerely, the camera crew.
Yes, I like zip ties. See, look, okay? If you like copying Brian Phillips RC, you can copy like this. And then my wife will complain about all the savings we had in zip ties.
You people watching can keep all the zip ties you want.
She just doesn't want me to.
Yeah, they don't live in my house.
Oh, whatever. We're always complaining we don't have enough zip ties. Oh, that one's short now. I didn't want to damage the finish. Yeah. This is a beautiful wheel, guys. The rim is made of obviously some sort of aluminum thing. And what I was going to say is,
they have a lot of packaging on that.
It's like actually designed by somebody.
To like
they
not
like knew
be
what
damaged.
They were thinking about doing. Okay.
Ooh. Okay. Okay, the kids will have fun with that.
Okay, so we'll keep that for later, obviously. I'm going to lay that down and we're going to look at the wheel. Weird.
Okay.
Nut.
Damaged.
Galvanized nut. Show the people. Hey, look at this.
That would have been
that would have kind of that would have come in handy on a bicycle that, you know, has a giant sharp object that is packed in a
might poke through the box.
Cardboard box. Especially even if you use like three layers thick of plywood.
Like there's not even any damage on the cardboard.
Goodness gracious, this will be good for something here. Obviously.
Totally.
I'm gonna use that thing like.
People, I have four children also.
Wow. This is actually sweet. Okay, so max inflation to 20. And I gotta say, this thing feels inflated already. Okay, sweet. I'm looking, this says 42B. Okay, so this is 100/90559MC, 26x4. Mm-hmm. Sweet. Okay, so that's a fat tire, obviously. And then here, 140 kilopascals. 1.4 bar, 20 PSI. Okay, so we have covered our bases with all different forms of measurement systems. I'm gonna lay this down. Isn't it nice when you have stuff just laid out? Convenience squared is what it said on the box. My wife is like, that's not the name, Brian.
It's not.
And she said it like that, and I was just being totally pleasant.
Right.
That's not it, Brian. So for those of you watching this video and you have no backstory on what we do here, we fly radio-controlled airplanes, and occasionally we do weed whackers. Okay, that looks pretty straightforward. Plastic, but sturdy. Okay, so that'll be fun to put on, minus the fun, plus
always.
A huge pain. I hate doing that step. I do like the fact that this is folded. That looks like really nice. Look at this.
Yeah,
that's
I like the
gorgeous.
Gray. Yeah.
So we're gonna have obviously some mount points here for something. I don't know what the heck all those doohickeys are. Is that like a supposed to built-in weakness? Whoa, this is adjustable. That's crazy. Now hold on, is that collapsible or is that just like you loosen it and then you can set it to however many degrees you want it? That's weird.
Okay.
Okay, so I found another tool, guys.
Oh.
So in case you don't wanna use the nice one, you can use this one.
Dude, that's what they used in China. They just forgot and left it in the box.
They left it in the box?
Yeah.
Whew, maybe. Okay, so let's keep going. This is some good stuff. We're finally making progress. We're cooking with gas. Okay? I just totally knocked a clip. Not into the disposal, but into the sink, maybe.
Oh, okay.
I am joking about the sink, but I did knock it. Man, that looks sweet. Oh, cool. Ballast?
No.
Basalt?
Basalt.
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 Oh, basalt. Oh, basalt and pepper.
This also comes in
Mokwheel. Mokwheel. So like
this. Just making up words.
Pretend
are you Chinese?
Wheels?
Yeah.
Like they're not real. They're
making
just
fun of you.
Wheels. Okay. we'll see how that works. Make fun of myself. That's enough.
Okay, but you...
This bike is hot because it was so hot outside. What?
The cat is...
Does the cat have an animal inside of its mouth?
No.
Okay.
She doesn't. I thought she did.
All right, so you can see this is... Goodness gracious, we went from like the worst packed bike in our entire time of doing this to probably the best packed bike.
That bike was actually... The actual bike itself was okay.
Oh, it was the package that got destroyed. Don't forget your nut saver.
Ooh, yeah.
Seriously. Guys, not just trying to be hilarious, but seriously. Okay. Then these things are pretty easy. That is like really nice.
That's cool. Is that a decal?
I don't know. It looks like it's probably a decal. Cool, I assume it's a decal.
It is.
Don't you think? I got the thing.
Okay.
You know the thing.
Good.
Okay.
Way to go with the thing.
I got the thing. By the way, one tip when you're unboxing these, keep all the stuff just in case, you know, something goes wrong and you have to pack it away. Or if you want to ship it to your buddy after you're done playing with it. Okay, that does not seem normal. Oh, it's going to brace.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the cooking board, or the cutting board, rather.
Make a snack.
I am trying to figure out where I'm going to... Because this yoke would normally be turned forward. Oh, that spins too right now. Is there an instruction manual? Yes, there is.
Yes, there was.
Okay. We don't normally do this on Brian Phillips RC because I'm a man. But we're going to look at these instructions. Is that even the bike?
Yes. It just doesn't have the...
Whoa, it is the bike.
The cutting board on the back.
Amazing. Yeah, they just don't have the cutting board option feature.
Yeah.
Oh, and there is a mud. Whoa, look how long that mud flap is. It goes all the way down to the bottom.
Nice.
That is kind of nice. It might actually work. Something some of these e-bikes don't have. Okay, attention. Okay, notice initial assembly and adjustment to your Mokwheel e-bike may be challenging and should be assembled with two people. That's actually great advice. Pay special attention to the areas marked by the caution symbol and all information in this manual beginning with notice. There's a reflection in the manual because this is like a waxy page. That's why I sound like I don't know how to read. Plug the power cord.
Cord.
Like musical cord?
That's like a musical cord.
Plug the power cord of the inverter into the socket sitting above the pedals of the seat frame. Okay. This manual contains details, blah, blah, blah. We're just going to keep going. Whoa, there's an entire set of instructions.
Wear sturdy shoes and eye protection?
Why am I wearing eye protection?
Maybe head protection would be good, though.
Okay, I've had enough of this page. 400 pounds, including the weight of riders and any fuel and clothing. You cannot take your naked measurements. Listen, people, this is important for you to know. I know this is a problem in some parts of the country. Not here, thank God. If you're going to ride naked, then you don't have to measure the clothes.
You can take more cargo.
But if you put the clothes on first and then you stand on the scale, you'll know how much you weigh. I am a scale technician. You can trust me. Okay, certified. I actually am. Seat frame. Oh, thank God, I know now. Pedal, okay. Ooh, LCD odometer. That's an odometer. It's an odometer. It's an odometer. Is that correct? Odometer?
That's right.
Okay, odometer. I think that's what they meant. Okay, oh, look, there's a pump in this one. I wonder what they're gonna use that for. Probably the tires, I'm guessing. Handlebar assembly. Just wiggle things and then move them. And
up and down.
Spin them.
And back and forth.
Next thing you know, it's a bicycle. I'm so confused. Why did they not just make a part that you stick on the end and tighten? Oh, I know why. So it's adjustable. Yeah, that's kind of scary. That's a lot of adjustable. Ugh. So if you're like really tall, you can be here. If you're really short, you can be here. Okay? I say that totally seriously, by the way. Okay? Does that make sense, guys?
Hopefully.
Adjust the angle of the brake and shift according to... accordingly before tightening all screws. This is actually pretty good English. I was, you know, starting expecting lots of things I could poke fun at, but not so much. Turn the bike upside down, adjust the angle. What?
headlight fender assembly.
Why would you turn it upside down to put the light on?
Yeah, no.
I'm pretty sure they didn't mean to do that at this step. Turn it upside down, then.
Well, they put the wheel on when it's upside down too.
I think somebody missed a step when they were putting these steps in order. I'm just looking for the step about the doohickey on the front, because that does kind of make sense. It's a multi-angle adjustment. Okay, left and right, that looks pretty straightforward. These are pretty good pictures, actually. Mm-hmm. You can kind of see like all the wavy things and moving parts, like this. Yeah, like wave it up, stick it in. Okay, all right. Look at this. Ooh, fancy. Standard ride, trip distance, eco mode. Pedal assist 0 through 5. Pedal assist setting, PAS, POS, pass. Custom ride, do they mean cruise control?
Battery A, battery B.
What?
Does it have two batteries?
Hold on a second here. There are not two batteries. Whoa, there might be.
I don't know.
Maybe there's one built in and then there's one that's removable. I don't know, that frame just looks like so beautiful. Like it's some animal.
What?
Look at it, it's all curvy and stuff. How the heck did they make that thing? Did they injection mold it out of steel? I don't know how they did that. Okay, total mileage, kilometers per hour. Average speed indicates the average speed for riding kilometers per hour. Okay, so I'm assuming that you can switch that because it looks like over here they have a unit.
Yep. Okay. See, this is the page you actually need.
If you're watching this multi-hour long video, just skip to this part. Yes, that's right. It's the part where the cat is annoying us. And so we stop filming the important parts and talk about the stupid cats. Motor overheat. Controller overheat. High voltage, low voltage, overcurrent. Throttle error. Motor phase loss. Good Lord. Haul error. Brake lever error. Turn signal error.
Turn signal.
Connection error. Okay. Well, those are the errors you can experience, folks.
Okay, great.
Charging methods. Recharge the battery on e-bike directly. Or you can remove the battery from the e-bike and recharge separately. Oh, geez. Full charge would take 5 to 6 hours. The estimated range with a single full charge is 30 miles. But not if you're...
It says
not if you you're were naked. Naked and 400 pounds. Then it's going to be much less. I'll let you know how much less. A lot less. By the way, guys, we don't ever listen to the mileage. Never.
No, it's never. Like worthless.
I don't care what brand you're talking to. It's there's too many variables for them to know. If you're 100 pounds and you ride that thing, you're going to go a lot further. You might even exceed 30. If you're 400 pounds, which I'm not quite, thank God, yet, then you are not going to make it as far. Weirdly. Especially if you're going uphill both ways.
In the snow.
Like go downhill, at least one of them. Battery charging tips. There's some battery charging tips. That's very... Do not touch the plus and negative terminals on the bottom of the battery.
Can I lick them?
Well, I mean, it's gonna probably hurt. Okay. Yeah, this looks pretty... Do not use it to power other electrical devices. Okay. You like how I pick one thing out and just skip the page? Brakes and shock absorption. Disc brake rotors may become hot during use. Okay, I hope you know that if you're riding a bicycle. Shock absorption. The function is for absorbing shocks and is adjustable by the switch according to the preferences. So you can turn that thing. It's usually like a half rotation. Increasing the shock absorption intensity on uneven roads or hillsides will reduce shock and vice versa.
Hey, they got that right.
This is crazy. They must have had an American write this.
That's pretty good. Minus the misspelling on cord. They're doing pretty good.
They were talking about zine.
You did do that. Nice job with that.
Thank you. I thought it was pretty awesome myself. Repair, replace if necessary. Wheel quick release adjustment. Oh, there's a quick release adjustment? I'm not seeing it. Maybe it's down there. Sometimes they're down there. Okay, so yeah, looks, this is like actually one of the nicest manuals we've had. If your bike is not working, check the connection cables, people. They're like this.
That's
like, that's exactly the way it looks. True. What is covered by your warranty? For 2 years.
Okay.
That stuff. Okay. Damage cost. How do you get service? About state laws. Okay. Yeah. When you see about state laws from a Chinese company, you can just take it and just crumple it right up and just go like, I missed the garbage can. All right. They have great capabilities. Good enough. Okay. You have seen the entire manual. That's the most useful part of the video. But just keep watching. There's more, I promise, maybe. All right, we're going
to
keep
what
working.
What were you trying to find?
I was trying to figure out if this was going to, because it's loose. I literally just didn't want it to fall over.
Oh. Because
okay. You see how this is shipped. Most of the bikes are shipped with the yoke horizontal, and so there's already like a supportive surface. But this is turned, so it's like, whoop. Did I get that right?
Yeah. This okay. One also already has the kickstand installed, so we could.
One complaint about this bike is that these stupid things popped out of the holes like that.
Yes.
Pretty minor issue.
But these boxes are really heavy.
They are extremely heavy. Even for me, I can't pick them up alone. So, and I am like Superman, right?
That was not a Superman voice.
Superman. Superman? Okay. I am kind of feeling like this is tipsy, and so I want to just kind of pivot it like this, okay? So I'm going to grab the yoke, I'm just going to walk it. If you could just spot me in case, like, the thing falls on my leg, and then, like, I mean, you want to get a shot of it first, and
okay.
Then point and laugh.
Yeah, definitely.
You, hey, you, like, maybe just let go, because, like, what should, I said spot me, and you're kind of making it hard. Wait, is it stuck? It is stuck, guys. That's why it wasn't you, it was the foam.
See?
Okay, so what am I gonna do? I'm gonna pull it towards, this is always like the most awkward step, for goodness sake. You think they'd come up with a better way for this, because it's, you know.
Can I pull the foam off the back?
Maybe most people don't have 11 or 12 of these bikes, I wonder. Hey, pull that off, but we're gonna put it right back on. Okay? Thank you, because yeah. Like, see how it's wanting to tip now?
Kickstand?
I'm only so magical. All right, yeah, the kickstand ain't gonna do us any good, you know.
Okay.
Okay, so continuing onward, I've upgraded my knee pads again. That's always convenient. Seriously, I just keep working my way up. Pretty soon I'll be sitting on a couch, not building an e-bike. All right, so you see this is squared-ish. This is like gotta be one of the weirdest apparatuses we've ever seen.
Yeah, this okay. Little, where are the handlebars?
They're right
oh, they're
here.
Over there, so.
Okay, so I found this tool. It was the one that was in the weird spot. It's all greasy, too, for extra good measure. I can't tell what the heck. That's why I wear gloves, guys, because I love getting grease all over me. Not grease, but oil in this case. Gosh, I cannot tell what way to turn this thing. Oh, you know why there's another one? You know why? Because look, it's probably spinning, and it is. You're going to need two of these.
Oh, whatever that size
number five. Is. Number five. Oh yeah, watch this. Opposing views. Oh my goodness. Oh, it was so easy to do in the drawing. That's terribly difficult, actually. What the heck? Is there like something I missed when I watched the wiggly lines? Am I like not doing this right? I guess it's kind of hard to tell. Nope, that's loosening. Okay, now that we've loosened, not enough. We're gonna keep loosening. It is getting a lot easier. That was hard to do, and I'm strong, and I do work with my hands for a living. So that was difficult. You may need two people, one for each side. Do you wanna take a minute and put that foam back in? Is that like, would you, oh goodness gracious, look.
Oh.
It came out.
Okay.
I hate it when it just spits out unexpectedly like that.
It's kind of short.
It's than I thought it was a little quicker than I was expecting.
Oh, it's like a whole little mechanism. Oh, just throw that anywhere.
Hmm. Okay.
On the floor.
Well, that's one way of doing it. You guys see this mechanism? Okay. Yeah. Yeah, this is a weird assembly, folks, I must say.
Yes, it is.
You got this doohickey. I don't know which way that was. See, this is the setting. This goes up and down. That's what you're supposed to undo. Oh my goodness, I'm such an idiot. See this? Look, now this slips up and down. I'm sure they drew that in the drawing, but I had no clue what they were talking about.
So you weren't supposed to undo the little side thingies?
I don't know. See this? There's paws up here that you catch. You're gonna have to probably like film this. See the paws? Hi, Paul. Nice to meet you, Paul.
What?
This is actually a paw.
That's what that's called?
Yeah, just take my word for it. If it's wrong, don't let me know.
That's true. They will. I believe you. I just didn't know that.
Paul, you're doing a terrible job. I just wanted to let you know I hate your guts. And see, there's no catchment points here, okay?
So you can only go so far.
Yeah. You have to stick it in the hole on this side. I don't know. Is it supposed to be like forward a little bit?
I mean, you're tall.
Yeah, I know, but this is like really freaking awkward. And then look, I've got this stupid thing now I got to put back in here. What a dumb design. Sorry, guys. We do reviews of products. Send us your products so we can tell everybody how dumb your design was. But honestly, folks, this is probably intuitive and easier for some people if they're not mechanical engineers. I don't know.
Well, some people might study the directions more.
You mean they look at the little wiggly lines and they're like, oh yeah, from this wiggly line, I can deduce that you need to use both of the screws and tighten both things. Okay, I gave up with that page. I'm on to the next one.
Do you want me to hold that up now?
Oh, for God's sake. I almost feel like we built a bike recently and we got really nice tools. And the problem is that bike was broken when we got it. And so I'm like in my head, I'm thinking, this bike does not have as nice a tool. And I wish we would have kept the, it keeps going down, I just want it to stay up, vertical. If you could just
hold your thingy up.
Well, I mean, or just do whatever it takes to keep it vertical on its own.
Well, sometimes this you is, have to help it
this
along.
This is like, really, this is like way getting too personal. Okay, let go. Paul, you're doing a terrible job. I hate the work you do for me. Okay, there's Paul.
Okay, so you
hold still, Paul.
So you didn't have to do that.
What?
You didn't have to do the little side thing.
I don't think I did, and I apologize, folks, for misleading you.
Jeez.
It's just like confusing because like this Paul, I don't like that design at all.
It is a little weird.
It did rhyme too.
Yes. So,
Paul, I didn't like the design at all. Do it in the right chord, hon.
The adjustability is nice, though.
C-H-O-R-D.
You spelled it right, too.
I know. I can do that. Yeah. I mean, if I see it in a book a few minutes before. not enough. All right, I'm going to go like this, guys. Since I screwed it up, I feel like there's like some attack monster outside
of
my
you're
deck.
Tightening that.
No. This is a critical safety device. Poles involved. We have to keep this squared away here, folks. Now, I think they suggest actually taking this off. So if you can just balance 17 things and hold Paul and all of his, you know what we could do? Let's go ahead and show the people the trick of the day. Trick of the day. It's time for the trick of the day. If you don't know how to do this trick of the day, learn how to do this trick by watching Brian Phillips RC struggle to do it in a totally ineffectual manner like I just did.
Yep.
With my wife's help. Remember, the instruction manual calls for two people. Sorry, you can't quit and go get pizza for the family, even though it's Friday night.
We have to explain that if you've been married for longer than 5 minutes,
oh, listen, all of this makes sense. If you haven't been married for more than we said recently, 18 years, but that's not correct.
No.
Just so you guys know, we said that just to throw you off of our scent because Paul kind of stinks.
It's been a long time.
And if you're confused, we get it. But yes, we have been married for many moons. Yes. You see what I just did there, guys? That worked really nice.
That was amazing.
You know why I do that, folks? Because there was this time a long time ago when I was, Oh, I'm so dumb. I went the wrong way. Oops. There was this time, see how I wrap my hand around it so it doesn't scratch the beautiful finish? This thing is like legit gorgeous.
Yeah.
I hope it looks good when it's all done. This is what I was talking, it's like an animal. It's like an animal. Do you see bikes like that very often? No. Unless they're e-bikes. Why is this thing so cattywampus? It's all get out.
Half on the cardboard and half.
I wouldn't be there if the stupid wheel was back there where it belongs. Will you grab it and just pull it, please? All the way? All the way? Okay. Now, there you go. Perfect. Okay. Yeah, it is slightly better now. You're right.
Okay.
Okay. So Paul's sort of doing his job now. It's still pretty terrible. And I need to put the handlebar on so I can try to tweak it. But I have to have this at least somewhat together so that I can put this thing up here. And for God's sake, look at this. They haven't even mounted this.
What?
Look. All this crap. Okay, you're going to have to genuinely put a hand on there.
Okay.
So that this doesn't fall. Because it's very hard for... That's why they say two people. But I don't think they anticipate the second's going to be filming anything.
Right.
That's kind of an unusual spot. Ooh. Muck.
It's like a little grippy.
Oh, yes. It's gel.
Cool.
These are nice brakes. You're not supposed to grab them, though, I heard once. Nice throttle. What if it drove into me? That would be hilarious. We should do that sometime in our video.
Drive into you?
No. Like, pull the trigger in an unbox and have it, like, run me over. It's like, terrible. It's terrible. Paul would never make such a bad joke. Paul's very level-headed, except for when you adjust him. Okay, if you guys don't know what a Paul is, it is a structure that catches another groove or something like that.
I've literally never heard that.
Well, now you know.
Thanks.
Yeah, you're welcome. You learn all sorts of stupid, useless crap from me.
I do.
Yeah. Okay, see this? Ooh, look at that. Ooh, oh, well, yeah, be careful with that. It kind of flies off. All right, so there's this aiming sight, so you can use this if you need some target practice with your... Not guns. BB guns, pellet guns. Arrows.
I don't think you can use it. With your...
Cab keys. Look, two of them.
Okay.
Put one of them away in your house. Put the other one in your pocket or in the thing, the bike. I say the thing, you know, the thing, because... If you lose it, these manufacturers are like, sorry, sir, you've lost your key. You'll have to figure out a way to hijack the bike.
Buy a new bike.
Which is funny because we broke one of the bikes. Actually, I didn't, and I was rather annoyed about it because I prefer to be the guy breaking the thing. Well, anyway, I came home to find out that somebody else's kid broke the thing. And it was on a scooter, an e-scooter, which is very nice. And it's like the one I use the most. And so I was super, super happy when I came home and it was broken. But it was only broken a little bit and they broke the key. And it was like, it would have taken the right person about 10 seconds to break it and then just like touch the wires together and you would have started it. So it's like, guys, you might want to just kind of investigate. Well, that is so oily. Look at this.
Mm-hmm.
Guys, that's why I wear protection. Wear protection. It will protect you from things. Okay. See this? Pal, you're doing a terrible job down there. I'm going to have to take this screw out. Can you just like actually hold that like you mean it?
Yes.
Not just like halfway?
Yeah.
Thank you. Because I'm afraid it's going to fall and it'll probably hurt you or me, but mostly me because I'm down here. You're way up there with the camera watching me and laughing. All right. So guys, these bikes, if you've never built a bike, you'll probably like think, oh my goodness, I cannot handle that. You can.
Yep.
It's just a pain in the butt.
Yeah.
It's more about like how many hours you're going to waste doing it. And that's really kind of what we think about when these bikes come. Because we're like, oh, look, a bike, yay, let's build it. I mean, I love riding them and they're super fun. But the builds are always a pain in the butt. And sometimes they're less aggressively a pain in the butt and sometimes they're more aggressively a pain in the butt. We try to showcase all of the whole story. And we do the same thing in the arena of RC airplanes. And I need to get a shop rag for my kitchen.
A shop rag.
Also known as a paper towel.
Well, it would be less of a pain in the butt too if you were like listening to music.
Yeah, just like, drinking, you know, drinking and a beverage, like the ones I got from the winery.
Yeah, it would be more fun.
The box said, thank you, leave. No, it said, thank you. There was no leave on there. See this? I'm turning this. And I feel like that marking is like where they want you to aim it for like some practical reason. But it's hard to tell because the bike is like, oh, wait. Yeah, see, they don't, I don't know. I wish they would stop putting those stupid aiming targets on there because it really is a preference issue anyway.
Yeah.
But it's just, it. This is, I say this all joking aside, guys.
Other arm.
I got hurt earlier this year and it wasn't from the concussion. That was on the same bike though, out of the blue. I don't know what I did wrong because nobody saw me fall and hit my head on the back here on the concrete because I didn't have a helmet on like an idiot. But I was in my own driveway, for God's sake. Anyway, the first time I crashed it, I had the handlebars loose here because I was like, I ain't no using no torque gauge.
That's exactly what you said. I remember it like it was not yesterday.
Well, anyway, I did that and then I crashed because the handlebar spun on this pivot point. And guess where I spun? Right off of the front of it.
Onto the ground.
But it was okay because I had a hat on that day. And so the hat goes like... And then, like, the little thingy on top was ground down to flush. And everybody's like, Daddy fell. He's going to die. Help Daddy, baby. Wait. No. They didn't say that.
They didn't.
Actually, everybody was kind of concerned, including myself. I was like, no, I'm fine. Because it wasn't near as bad as it could have been. Because I didn't, like, hit the back of my head on concrete. And I know some of you guys are worried about how the concrete fared. Which you pointed out nicely in the comments after I told you about the crash and my subsequent concussion.
I feel bad. The concrete's fine. We got the fiber reinforced.
The stutter's new. The concussion. I've been giving out business cards. If I said anything that was embarrassing, just remember, I'm a brain injury victim. Recent brain injury victim. Actually, I should be almost over that brain injury soon.
Yeah, hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully.
Hope you don't fall again.
That would be a bummer. So I have to wear a helmet, huh?
Yeah.
Dang it. I mean, I love helmets. Actually, the Nitto helmet we have is very nice.
Yes.
And it really does work good, and I like it, and it's light, and I have adopted it for my powered paragliding.
You just don't wear it when you ride bikes in our driveway.
In our driveway. I also don't wear a bicycle helmet when I'm going to the bathroom on a toilet either. Or when I'm sitting on the couch watching TV.
How many people have fallen off the toilet and gotten a concussion?
I'm sure it's happened. Let's take a poll. If you've fallen off the toilet and you've hit your head, please definitely leave it in the comments below because I'm gonna need somebody else to point and laugh at because I'm gonna be tired of being laughed at by the end of this one. Not with, at. There's a difference, people. Okay, so Nylox, give me a break of your KitKat bar, please. Why was this not already installed? Why was this not already installed? Why was this not already installed?
Because it has to go around the thing.
The thing that was in the box, and I could have still mounted that.
Yeah, but then you would have been in the way of your nuts.
Those are bolts, but I know you prefer nuts. So I'll just leave it at that, and it's fine. But seriously, guys, if you want an e-bike, these e-bikes are super fun. You'll love them, especially the assembly.
You only have to build it once.
And seriously, it's worse. Like if you've done 20 of them, you'll disdain it more after the 19th. Maybe. It depends on if you love building stuff. You know, I cannot tell. Does it go this way? Yes, yes. It does. I was kind of joking. So if you're new to the channel, what do we do here? We unbox things, we put them together, and we show all the mistakes the manufacturers made right after we take the product to review it and tell you all about the mistakes they made. And then the things that they did well, we also point out. And all joking aside, this does look like it's gonna be a pretty awesome bike, but I still kind of don't. Oh, 750 watt, 28 miles per hour, class 3, it says right on there. Oh. And that way, when you're like, the police are like, stop, police, e-bike user, danger. Pull over now. What are you doing? Are you some sort of a crazy person? And they're like riding a Harley that'll go like 195 miles an hour in like 5 seconds.
Right.
But you're the crazy person.
I don't think we have any of those around here.
What, the cops?
Not the ride motorcycles.
Oh no, they just want to ride. They're like, hey, that looks pretty cool, man. Let me ride it. It's like, okay. This does look nice.
Yeah, it's cool.
Gel, squishy. I like squishy pears.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Not very big, but.
Okay, hold still for a sec. I gotta try to, see this? It's not lined up, but that's okay. I mean, who needs your front handlebar lined up? That's gonna be easier after the tire's on. Admittedly, okay. Guys, my tire's not lined up straight. That's all my fault, and Paul's, but mostly Paul's. What?
What?
I need to center this because this is not, it's off by like 4 degrees. It's gonna, that means I'm gonna be riding and I'm like, why am I going into the ditch? I'm going straight. I don't wanna be that guy.
Okay.
I already demonstrated it. I don't need to actually do it.
So how do you adjust that?
You loosen these screws. Oh. Yeah, I know. I agree. I was going to just try to do it before I put the wheel on. Yeah, that's not going to work very easy because I need to loosen it more. So guys, if you're new to the channel and you're trying to wonder what the heck you're watching and why you're still watching it, we would also like to know.
Sure.
So leave it in the comments below if you enjoy this type of footage where you see a married couple that's old and has been working together way too much.
And we never argue, ever argue, say anything bad.
We're always
on camera.
Really
the
happy.
Sweetest people you'll ever meet.
Never disagree about anything because we're just a regular married family. It's a perfect married family. Married family, it's kind of weird. Married husband and wife.
Yeah.
That's what we are, right?
Okay. Yeah.
Still good.
Still.
Whoo, dodged a bullet. I did just straighten that, folks, if you can tell. The camera crew held the camera in a different angle to give you a precariously different view.
Mm-hmm.
Now watch this. I'm going to slide this doohickey onto that, and I'm going to torque, and I'm going to do it carefully so I don't scratch this beautiful finish. I really hope I don't crash this one.
Yeah, you should try to not do
into
that.
Into a tree.
Well, don't do that.
So my friend crashed his mall that was already crashed multiple times into a very tall tree.
Very, very.
Very, very tall tree. We could totally publish that clip right now. Should we?
We should.
That would, okay, so if you want
to
see it.
I have to edit this whole video.
We could stop it.
That's okay.
There's going to be totally an Easter egg.
I'll picture it.
No, we're going to do an Easter egg. Easter egg starting now. Stop the video.
So they have an extension ladder. Okay, so Brian's right there, and this is our extension ladder, and then Esteban is up here, and then he has the stick of shame. It's going all the way up to the mall. Yeah, the battery in the nose is sitting on my driveway. I don't know where the wings are. I'm so sorry I was gone for that.
Let it down, okay? You got a broom pole on the end of that.
So this video is to inform my neighbor that there were some crazy weirdos crawling up a ladder into a tree because some moron crashed his plane in the middle of it. And I've never done anything like that except for 3 or 4 days before.
Yep. Yeah.
There's a ditch down there. We started on that side and we got half of it down. And then the other half last night, we got the wings broke off because this was such a tragic accident that not only did we break the wings off, but all four of the motor mount.
Jeez.
Broke. Yeah.
Where is the plane now?
It's right there in the middle of this ditch.
We'll oh, I see it.
Next. So yeah, that was fun, wasn't it? Esteban? Do you like how I hold you hostage for videos?
That's all right.
And yes, we have the Sticko Shame all the way extended, plus an extension on the end of it, plus an extension like this. And at one point we had the painter's stick. And that's the best way to do it, these little two inch like finish rollers. You just pull the roller off. That's the way to do it, guys. If you're not crashing, you're not flying. If you're not flying, you're not crashing. All right? Stay tuned. So much more to come. From Esteban RC.
Oh, that was hilarious, wasn't it? Did you see me standing on the bottom holding the ladder while he was on the top of the ladder in my neighbor's tree with a stick of shame? It was awesome. Okay, if you didn't see the clip, we apologize. But honestly, that would be so rude. But we are probably gonna show that Easter egg. So Esteban, if you're watching, eat your heart out.
Sorry.
You're welcome.
Don't crash into
the tree. Don't crash into the trees anymore. Hey, which is funny because I did crash into the same tree just like days
Yours
before.
Just didn't get
but
stuck.
I only clipped like literally that much and only by one wing. And it used to sit here and look beautiful. But now it's even more big and beautiful. That's a Ranger 1.8. Hopefully you've seen that video by now because it is a good plane. I love it.
They have.
Well, just because it's released doesn't mean they watched it. Oh, wowzers. That thing is bouncy and eager. Listen. Oh, I thought it was something else. Okay. All right. We need to probably think about doing something to make this not tip by you staying there. Okay.
Okay.
Don't get distracted by the cutting board and like try to make dinner or anything.
Okay. I'll try not to.
I have to put this wheel on, folks. That's kind of the next big move. I hate this step. Admittedly, it's very awkward. Even with two people, it's never as easy as you want it to be. And there's a couple of things that I have to do down here. Okay, so the brake is on Megan's side. So I got the brake lined up. And by the way, we were talking about these ugly things.
Those like, are terrible.
Terrible.
Yeah.
You're gonna put a beautiful reflector on and then you're gonna put that ugly thing. I gotta say, come up with a better solution,
yeah,
folks.
Those are pretty bad.
China, do it right. Don't cheat, China. Okay. Oh wait, is this one of those like this design in the USA but made with global supply chain parts?
No, it says made in China on the box.
Oh, it's just straight up made in China. And proud of it. Although I gotta say the manual is pretty awesome on this for being made in China.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm assuming this is the back brake. How about this, camera crew? You just go ahead and I don't want to brake on this because sometimes it makes the, that's the back brake. Okay. Okay. Let go of the brake. Very nice. Okay, the cutting board is in the way. Can you pull the foam out? I'm sorry. Okay, see if we can put the cutting board. Oh, is that a brake light?
Yes.
Hey, did you just really pull that?
No.
Let's pull that, pull the cutting board up right now. Oh, geez, Megan. Does it slide?
Yeah, okay, it does.
Good. Woo! Okay, now, this is why I said it was an awkward moment. Mostly, what are you doing? Okay, now, there's tricks to do this easier. We just didn't use them, okay? First of all, once we identified which brake was the rear brake, we could have put a zip tie on it. We should have. That's what we're gonna do next, and then we're gonna reposition some foam, but I kinda need all hands on deck to just get the foam in the right spot. Sorry, so we'll pause and give you another clip of Esteban in the tree. Okay, zip tie, around. Okay, This is just super easy peasy. And you're just gonna go like this. Now, if you do it right, you'll kind of go over here so you're not on the foam and you don't damage anything, but you have to kind of hold that down a little bit. Okay, so that is hopefully not gonna slip off. If it's gonna slip, you have to tighten it more, okay? That's gonna hold the brake. And you're like, you're really gonna do that? Yeah, I'm gonna really do that because I don't have a bike stand. But while we're down here, let's look at something. See, this is the battery. That's the release. And then the battery would probably come out with gravity. And then there's plugs over here for the charging. Okay, one here. And there must be, that's another plug. I have no clue what that plug does. Oh, is that how you plug the two together?
Is that where the thing says to?
To stick it in the hole?
Yeah.
I don't know, I guess. So you can also get a good look at this. Overlord. Is that what that says? Overlord?
Looks like it.
Okay.
Okay.
And then this is a Tektro? Okay.
Sure.
Whatever. And then this is a shipping bolt. So really all I'm gonna do now is I just need to basically come up with a camera crew to hold the top. And if you hold the top and you can't keep it, like maybe you hold it so that it doesn't move. You could hold here, like next to Paul.
Okay.
Thank you. Just keep it steady. Now, admittedly, we've said this numerous times now. This step is annoying. It's difficult to do. It is challenging and it's obnoxious, but we're gonna get it done anyway. That's not it. I don't know why that's in there. 15 millimeters, not correct. Okay, also not correct. Okay, well, I guess I don't need a tool. So this is the apparatus that keeps the yoke apart, right? And then you just use these double-ended screws for whatever you want. All right, so now the tire and the brake. This is where you don't want to have the brake applied. There's sometimes a filler inside of here, and there is this time too. Cam crew is going to have to hopefully keep focus.
Are you going to show, where's the filler thing?
I was just filming it. See this? This is going to come out.
Oh, okay.
And that keeps your brake pads apart.
Okay.
Because you don't want to have to spread them at an inopportune time. Now I'm just loosening this, and then I believe this goes on the inside in most cases. So I'm going to leave that on the inside. I'm going to put this as far out as I can get. Far out, dude. And honestly, you know, it's going to go like that. It's totally good. Did it show in the manual? Probably didn't.
Probably not.
Hey, hold that like you mean it.
Okay.
Going in. You have to hold it like you mean it because I'm pressing against you.
Good.
You're not holding it.
I'm trying.
Okay. It's because I hit the brake on the disc brake. If this falls, it's going to hurt my fingers or my toes. Probably my toes. Okay, I'm going to take this nut off because I can't get it to go. I'm going to lay it in a reachable area. Like I said, there's more than one way to do this, admittedly, but we have struggled with every single one of them, so we're just trying this a little different tonight. Oh, yeah, in the hole. Now we're going to see if this spacer is supposed to be on the inside or the out. The way we're going to know is by doing it.
Okay.
Now I'm pretty sure it kind of seems like maybe that's supposed to be on the inside. Dang it. I honestly can't tell. I think it's supposed to be on the inside.
Do you need to look? I can hold this.
Son of a biscuit lover. Yeah, let's just check. I'll check the manual.
You don't have to just tell the people.
I'm going to tell the people and show them if I can find it.
Okay.
So now the assembly instructions on these front, as usual, completely no close-up. Useless information.
Always, like, this is the one.
This is the one thing that is not very, very obvious, and they never have a picture of it. It's so annoying. And now, I guess my question is, I don't think the yoke will allow them in there.
Okay.
I think I'm just gonna back this off and pull it out, and I'm just gonna tighten it. That bearing surface is good. It's getting done that way. It's on. It's on like Donkey Kong, trademark. Not us. What?
Do I have to hold really tight?
Okay. Yeah. Because I'm torquing the wheel on. I mean, do you want the wheel to jank off while I'm riding?
Probably not.
By the way, I'm gonna point one thing out to you folks at home. Okay, tight. Now, you're gonna keep holding.
Okay.
I'm gonna hold the camera. Thank you?
Yep.
Okay, so look at this, folks. The camera crew right here. Look at this. It's a screw on the bottom. You will never think about that thing again, as will you not think about that thing. So this would be a good time to verify. By the way, this thing is gorgeous, beautiful. Okay, all right, so now that we have the wheel on, we should be able to carefully change the hands. And all I'm gonna do now is I'm basically gonna pivot this down so you can see this. This is like super easy. I don't even have to hold the brake. Yay, look at that, amazing. Super easy process. All you have to do is rip the bag off and then you're ready to ride. And all those other steps that we did. That's a wide seat, I like that. That should work good for my butt. Wait, there's a kickstand. Okay, so I'm gonna just kinda, whoa, geez. Oh, there's a quick release and it's just not tightened. That needs to be tightened a little bit. I'm gonna just pull this. Oh yeah, I'll have to tighten it with a tool right there.
Okay.
Oops, gosh dang it. I'll just torque it a couple of turns and then just quick adjust. Okay, should be good. All right, so now I wanna cut my zip tie. Is it sitting? Oh, it's sitting, it that's so sweet. That's a big bike, dang.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, folks, when you get an e-bike, I'm gonna tell you this, and you're gonna think I'm full of crap until you buy one and it's the wrong size. You have to get the right size bike. Everybody in China is gonna tell you every bike fits every human ever.
Yeah.
They're like 5'2 to 6'7.
Yeah, no.
We have an e-bike that the seat goes like this high on. And I'm like, what are you doing with the seat? Are you like holding, are you sitting on your belly and reaching down? So, I mean, we've seen some crazy stuff on these e-bikes. I do like that the weight's up front too, because then you're gonna have the driver and then the weight's up front. And this does have a little bit of relief. We're gonna find out if this bar hits the jewels of the family.
So the step through option would be better if you're shorter, especially.
Is that an option?
Or if you're still in childbearing years. Yes.
Well, it's an option then.
It is.
Okay, good. Okay, so I'm gonna cut this zip tie and then it's gonna like roll away.
Okay.
Ah! What? Like you've never heard me scream. So you see this? Look at this. Boom. Okay, so the cutting board is only one screw, but then there's 47 screws. Where's the rest of them supposed to go?
The headlight.
Yeah. Okay, we gotta cut off this stuff here. Guys, honestly, these unboxes are probably some of the most like involved unboxes that we have, unless it's a Dynam. And then the answer, if you guys don't know what a Dynam is, you're probably not gonna be one watching the RC airplane videos, but they make RC airplanes and they're, we kind of stopped using their planes because they were so difficult to work with and just really didn't make a very good product. Even though we liked the people we worked with that sold them, and we did try our best for like years to try to get them to be better and they just never would. This bike is beautiful. Gotta put some pedals on there maybe.
My help.
I don't know if I'm like a huge fan of the reflective line. It's a little bit of a style that's maybe not mine, but the thing is I'm gonna like it when our neighbor's going down the road with his boons in hand.
The reflective on the wheel?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, I like, it's kind of take or leave. I think it's kind of like, it's a style. You have to want it, okay?
But functionally, we ride at night a lot, so I think it will be good. We do a lot.
Like most of the time we ride, it's at night.
Yeah.
Obviously we film, you know, during the day so you guys can see better, but we ride at night almost every night that we're riding. Okay. So just looking at it, where am I missing? I got to do pedals.
Yeah, foam over here.
Okay. And then we got to get this thing cut off, which yep. I don't even know why. Oh, there's a zip tie. No. No, it's just like a lot of bag. Like what the heck?
Go like stretch your sack out a little bit more.
Well, I feel like I'm giving it a vasectomy with all this. No, there's a zip tie in there.
There
what
is?
The heck is going on? No, they have a rubber band. Who put the rubber band on there? Kick that guy out of the factory. Oh, you put the rubber band, you're fired. What?
It's like a lot of plastic. I just want you to know.
It's really, really difficult to cut through it too because it's super strong and sturdy and perfect. I mean, if you want to keep your shaft clean, this is the way to do it. I mean, I just assume not have to cut 14 times. Good Lord. Oh my goodness. Seriously. And then some of you are like, why didn't you just take the chair off and slide it off the top? Listen, we can't all be geniuses right here. Obviously, we're filming this video. All right, so, boy, going back to the same size. It's hilarious. They gave us a whole set, and I think
and
we've used one size.
Two.
No, two, actually. Ooh, this bent. This is bent. What the heck? Did they put it in the wrong hole? That'll get you in trouble.
Yeah, well.
All right.
Or does it just have to get manipulated?
So you're saying, what the heck happened here? That ticks me off. My cutting board has broken paint. By the way, China, if you're listening, give us touch-up paint.
Yeah.
Dang it. I was going to show that in an extreme close-up.
We already did.
Oh. See, that's what we do on Brian Phillips RC. We point out all manufacturing defects and never take responsibility for any of our own.
Defects? We already told them we've been married a long time. That should cover most of it. Seriously, the cat.
Ugh, that cat is so annoying.
Can I let her in now?
No, no. She needs to stay out there. Sorry. Go hunt something, please. That's the cat that does all the heavy lifting in our household.
No, if the other one does. But she disappears for like weeks at a time.
Oh, Colby. That's Callie that's jumping up. But I have trained her that if I let her in, I don't let her jump up. Yeah, that's right. I trained a cat. You know how hard it is to train a cat?
It's obviously
it's actually impossible.
It's working really well.
No, she doesn't see me. I'm blocked. I'm obstructed. Okay, so you guys see this problem? Like, it's not going to line up very good.
Just wrangle it over there.
And then this clip. Oh, geez. I like literally bent that. Like literally and figuratively bent that. I'm glad you don't have like hands blocking your entire view or anything.
We can see now.
This is like really awkward, like terrible awkward. Like seriously, I can't get this started because there's so much side pressure on it.
Do you want me to push?
You already have four kids. Hey, but seriously though, look, look underneath the cutting board. There's two screws here and this is allowed to pivot this way. And I'm wondering if part of the problem is this is supposed to be loosened.
Loosened?
China. China sent us screw. They sent us this thing. Look. Oh, that is so awkward. Yeah. It's, oh, my goodness. Next thing is that thing is going to shoot across the room.
Yeah,
holy cow, like I cannot release it, guys. Never mind. Okay, so this is gonna be an awkward point here. Okay. So you guys see the problem, right? This needs to walk over. I just walked it over. Now I need to walk it back. Oh, okay, there we go. See how now that I'm not putting all that side load on there, I think it'll be fine. Okay. Yeah, that'll work.
Because you have to get it through both holes.
Yeah, at the same time.
That's awkward.
I mean, you would think I have a lot of practice getting through both holes, but I mean, it's like, come on.
Usually they don't like mesh up like that.
Well, you know what? When they're made in China. I am having a really hard time getting the threads to cooperate with me on this, just so you guys can understand why I'm fighting. And it's largely to do with the angle of attack of the screw. And I understand your view is pretty rough right now, so I do seriously apologize for that. Because here's the thing. Okay, so like if I take this out of contention, meaning the cutting board.
Okay.
Holy crappers. If I take that out of contention, I feel like it's possible. Oh, 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 oh! No. I don't want to cross-thread the hole.
Ooh,
oh, yeah, it's like all you have to do is screw it in at an angle, folks.
Oh.
Yeah, that's not straight. That's like 3 degrees off a square. No, it's not. It's perfect. I'm just wrong. I don't want to admit it. Chinese are amazing manufacturer geniuses.
Never screwed up anything ever.
No. No, never. I take it all back. Mokwheel. Mokwheel. That's why there's so much mocking going on in this video.
Right.
Because it's called Mokwheel. They told us, like, you need to mock the wheels. Actually, those high-vis tires are kind of cool because, oh, jeez, this is going to be kind of a little bit thin for a humanoid, just so you know.
It's not designed for that.
No, I know. You put your meat there and you cut it, or, you know, vegetables if you're vegetarian.
Make a snack if you're...
You know, that thing is actually in there pretty tight.
Okay.
I am super annoyed about that black paint chip. That's super, super stupid. Hey, what is this bike called? The Basalt?
The Basalt.
Like assault or
no,
basalt?
Basalt.
Like, so, like...
Basalt is a... Oh, what is basalt? It's a word.
Basalt is a word?
Yes.
Is it like boskage?
No.
I don't know. Maybe you should, like, consult an English dictionary.
No, we don't know.
Okay, so the derailleur looks nice. It's a Shimano. Shimano. Okay, you know, I got tons of screws up there.
Do you want to put a pedal on while you're over there?
Yeah, I was thinking about that, but then I have to get up to get it anyway.
Okay.
So, folks, if you're watching this and thinking, good Lord, these guys suck at building bikes, you would be correct. But just believe me, when you get yours, you'll hate it just as much
you'll
as we did.
You'll fuck at it too.
But the truth is, it actually seems like it's going together reasonably well other than that one screw. And to be honest, we've had more problems with mud flaps than we had on anything else on e-bikes.
Yeah. Well, there's four screws that are going to go in the front for a light.
How about we figure... What? Four screws?
Well, there's four holes.
Oh, good Lord.
I want your light to be secure.
Yeah, like, am I going to be hanging on it?
Maybe.
Hey, I'm serious law, though. I'm serious law. Going to need... Can you get me the other one? Yes, it's the next size, the one that's out. Okay. This is the right way, isn't it?
I don't know.
Well, look at the picture. Tell me if it's right. Megan, look at the picture. You don't need to show this. Where are you? Are you going to, like, the grocery store?
Yeah, I believe it. It's time for pizza.
Goodness gracious.
Front wheel installation.
Yeah, the front wheel. Show them how detailed that drawing
is. Yeah, that was super helpful.
It's like front wheel installation.
It doesn't say anything. I think the mud flaps are extra.
Megan, look at the picture.
There's no mud flaps on the picture.
I have to assume I'm doing this right because there's an attachment point down here.
Yeah.
But I don't know. That might be like a little bit too far back.
But there's no hole in the front.
Yeah, there isn't, is there? Well, but it could reach inside. Gosh, I'm not sure. I think that's right. That looks right, doesn't it?
Right. Yeah.
Okay, let's pause. We'll check. Sorry. All right, so we were playing with our nut and bolt sack. And I think that thing is a spring separator for the brake pads. I don't know if I need it. It doesn't say anything in the instructions. And so I'm going to put it in a bag with my extra brake pads. And then I'm going to put that stuff over here next to the gift card. And I'm going to keep all that stuff into perpetuity so it can annoy my wife.
Yes. Thank you.
You're welcome. And then I have 1, 2, 3, 4 screws, 1, 2, 3, 4 washers. Okay. Then I have 1, 2 small screws, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I believe they're the same length. There's a couple that are a little bit longer, it looks like. And then some more big ones. And then there's these things, which are L brackets that probably are going to adapt. Then there's a couple of nuts and lock washers. I believe those are redundant to go here in case you would break them. Okay. And then there's like a few more of these washers and then a few more of these washers. And I'm like, I have no clue why we have so many spare parts. It's very annoying to not know what they're for. But at the same time, we're going to pick back up where we left off. I'm going to put my nut savers right on. Boom. And boom. They are hard to push on. That's normal. Ugh. At least in my experience for pushing on nut savers. I don't even think I got that all the way on. Oh, good Lord. They suck to put on. They look a lot nicer than just the bare nuts. Who wants to look at bare nuts riding around? I mean, especially since you only allowed 400 pounds. Hey, that worked pretty good, actually.
That seemed dangerous.
And if you guys hear yelling, it's just the humans in our basement.
They're fine. They have lots of snacks.
They do. And TVs. Video games and
tablets.
And stuff. They're probably going to be like, I don't want to come upstairs. Why would I want to do that? Okay, so there's a left and a right. So this is a right if you're in China facing us.
Right.
This is a left and this is a right. Okay. So real quick, we'll just get this turned in. Then the camera crew is going to grab my tool so that I can tighten it. Which... very, very easy. Just get me the smaller one. Did you move all the tools or just the one I needed?
Just the one you needed.
Okay. Okay, so that's torqued on. Then we'll put the other one over here. It's gonna be amazing. All right. Thank you for being so low, so it's easier. I could spin it, except I have a giant piece of foam in the back wheel. So guys, if you wanna buy one of these for yourself, it's the best way you can support us on YouTube here is just buy the stuff we review. When you like something, we don't expect you to ever buy anything you don't like, but it is kind of a lot of work to put these videos together, and it helps us to finance our channel. When you do buy stuff, it does support us financially by small commissions from the manufacturer to us, but only upon your purchase, and it doesn't cost you any extra. And of course, you can use coupon codes that we usually list at brianphillipsrc.com or in the video description below, depending on the plane, bike, leaf blower, etc. Okay, so these things are gonna go back over here. There's two keys. I don't know where they go yet. We're gonna find out. So they're still there, and we were working on the front mud flap. We do have it in the correct orientation, as you can see. I'm gonna pull up a chair, because this next step is gonna suck, because it's always a pain to put these lights on. Now, real quick, you don't have any charging to do on this. You just plug it in, which is really nice, okay? It's got lights. Did I do that good enough for you?
Yep, that's great.
So plug this in now, you can see it's keyed. See it's keyed? Meaning you can only put it in one way and do not spin it, okay? And then this is going to go back here on that thing, okay? It's gonna be trapped in the mechanism. And what they suggest is putting this between that thing, okay? And I'm caught now on the tire, so of course you need four hands to do each of these steps. And that's the way that's supposed to go, just like that. But it does seem like that's going to want to fall down a lot. So we're gonna find out if we can get that started. Now, easiest way I've found to tighten these is to use the provided tools that are the correct size.
Is that how that works?
Yeah. Okay, so just tightening this on. And then what we'll do is we'll come back when we realize what we've done wrong and fix it.
No, redo it?
Yes.
Just when we do it twice for each step?
Yes. Okay. Maximum penetration. Okay, so now once I get this sort of tight, here's what I'm gonna do. It's not tight, but it's sort of tight, okay? So it's got a little bit of pressure and a little bit of bite. Now you can set this up higher if you wanna get a little bit more clearance, like if you're gonna ride on bike trails where you're gonna have more potential for picking up rocks and debris. And then you can bring it down closer if you wanna like make it look like some sort of a lowrider. And that's totally up to you. Amazing features built into this bike. Okay. Are we gonna like cut up some like onions and stuff?
Watermelon.
I don't wanna put watermelon juice on that.
So if you put onions on it?
Yeah. Oh, onion. Okay, so now we have the light. As you can see, it's beautifully mounted, and we have a reflector that is just kind of bent into position. Now, the thing I like about this light is you can adjust that on the fly while you're riding, I hope, maybe. Because it is nice to be able to unblind the people driving at you. Now, remember, if Paul annoys you, you can annoy him back by taking and loosening this, and then you can adjust where your handlebars sit. Now, we usually do those adjustments before we ride for our maiden. And so you're not gonna see it necessarily in this video because I might need this to be closer or further. But you can only adjust on this portion, on the front portion, okay? From like about here down to about there, okay? All right, so now this has to be mounted to that somehow. And you're like, well, what the heck? Those holes don't line up very good. See this? Okay.
Is that what those bracket things
are? So this is going to loosen and it's gonna be allowed to extend. Yeah, I mean, I would assume that that's what these brackets are for. Then these are gonna go here, or some configuration of the sort. Yeah, pretty sure it's gonna be like that. No, it's gonna go like
like this, okay?
So now we just need to find the right screw that actually goes through. Now, it looks like these screws have a pan head to them, and they're Phillips. So they're gonna go like that, and that's the one I wanna use. And it's ironic because it's the only tool they didn't provide.
Now, this might not be the right thing either. Let's see, yeah, that goes in there very nicely.
Okay, so they did not provide a Phillips screwdriver, so I'm gonna grab one from this other set that I have sitting here. Nothing special, just like a number two screwdriver.
This is where you're supposed to turn it upside down.
What are you talking about? Why would you turn it upside down?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
And it doesn't tell you what hardware to use either.
No. So look, if you don't have a Phillips screwdriver, okay, then just pretend you've got one and use the tools and then the other hardware. Because there's probably a way you can just use the other hardware. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just tighten this. But I think at some point I'm going to have to extendo these so that there's clearance for the wheel. Can you show them what I'm talking about? See, when this is tight, it's gonna be tight on the wheel. So I'm gonna probably have to loosen this and then extend this out. Okay, so I'm not sure if that needs to go this way or if that needs to go that way. It looks like that's wrong. So I would suggest it's probably gonna go this way, okay? These apparatuses are always such afterthoughts on these bikes. Mm-hmm. It's like they built this really sophisticated machine, okay? What the heck? You're supposed to have a washer on, aren't you? Yeah, I'm supposed to have a washer because I'm not getting any purchase here, meaning I'm bottomed out on my screw. Yep, I'm bottomed out, okay. So I'm gonna back this back out. And they're like, just put a bunch of washers in there in case they need them. Like maybe you could take a close-up picture. Oh wait, hold on, I just figured out their game plan. They're like, oh, send to Brian, he fix it. I wonder if that's it.
Yep, totally.
They're probably like, well, we didn't think that was the way to do it, but we're glad you figured it out.
We could take one picture or make you watch a 57-minute long video.
No, well, 57-minute video makes sense to me. I think that's really the more appropriate way to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I think you have to loosen this, yeah, because why would you not need 14 tools to mount a freaking mud flap? Why?
Maybe you don't want a mud flap.
Well, if the bike comes with a mud flap, I'm putting the mud flap on.
Wouldn't you want a mud flap? Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like mud flapping on me. Oh, you could put screws in the front.
Why would you do that, though?
Because there's nothing in there, and it's going to hold water if it's raining. So loosening this, watch. This is going to allow this to extend a certain amount. I don't know how much. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Fancy dance. Fancy dancy. Okay. See? We'll leave this loose for the moment. Good Lord, this is like the most complicated structure I've ever seen in my life. This is so annoying. Like, why did they not make this simpler? This is ridiculously complicated.
Well, and if there was like two pieces of hardware, you would just know what to use, but there's like eight.
Okay, so yeah, and now I'm just, hold on. I have to do process of elimination because this doesn't just go together like you think it should.
Why would you put them?
Because they're open sockets. You don't ride around a bicycle with open sockets. You stick something in the opening. Yeah, you should know by now.
I know, but you don't just like stick anything in there.
Well, the idea is you don't want it to get wet.
Then why is there a hole there?
Because you can mount the advertising thing there,
yeah,
I guess.
No.
I don't know. Hey, but seriously, look at all these screws. They're like all freaking different sizes. What the heck were they thinking?
I don't know.
Look at this, guys.
They just had some leftovers that day.
They're like, whatever, just throw them into Brian's system. He'll figure it out. See, look, here's one. It's the only one like it.
Yeah.
Is that like a spare part?
It's like it's the same as this one.
Okay,
this is the
whatever.
Only one.
You get rejected. Okay. Then there's a bunch like this size. Ooh, is that the one that goes here? Nope. Okay, does this one go here? See, what I'm saying is, okay.
Does it go in the other hole, though?
Just relax for a second. Of course it's going to go through the other hole, because I'm going to stick it in there.
It doesn't mean it's supposed to go there.
Well, I suppose that's, you know, one way of looking at it.
Okay, see this? I'm gonna start this. Now I need to decide if this needs to be the other way because it's not immediately obvious. I hate to break it to you.
No, it's not, I agree.
It should be, but you know, like, shoulda, woulda, coulda. Oh, for God's sake, yes.
Yes!
Yeah, but that's not like screwed on.
Yeah, there's no nut to put on there. Oh, those nuts are the wrong size. Okay, so that answers my question. All right, folks. Yes, just listen. I will explain. Listen, I will explain. First, you need to re-engineer this whole thing. Then you need to loosen this thing. Then you need to pull this off, okay, because we did it wrong, okay? I mean, based on the drawing with like the wiggly lines, that obviously didn't work.
If you would have had the bike upside down, this totally
this would have been easier, way easier. Yeah, I would have been able to do it no problem. It's just because we break directions.
Yep.
Okay. Oh, yep, wrong size. Why would it just go? Okay. Ah, there it is. Yes. So I'll show you, and you guys will understand in 30 seconds, I promise. I'm going to take this out, and then I'm going to flip it around. I'm going to stick it in from the back. That's right. You heard it first on Brownfield.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm going to hold this, and I'm going to hold that, so I don't have to find him. Then I'm going to loosen this, and look what just happened. Oh, yes. You didn't call me out for the Michael Jackson squeal?
What was I going to call you out for?
Oh, I need a washer. Give me washers. Let's make sure. Oh, that is a terrible fit. Not the right washer. It's the wrong washer.
Two sizes of washers.
There's four sizes of washers. Okay, that's the correct washer. The only problem is, oh no, do I need those up top for the hole pluggers? No. Nah, let's just do that. That looks good. That looks totally obnoxiously wrong and good.
I do not understand.
You don't understand how that just happened in front of your eyes? I did it until it was right, and then I was done, and I'm like, hey, look at that. Amazing. Miracle. Thank God I have built something before.
That screw seems way too long.
What? Are you afraid it's going to, like, trap in here?
No.
There's just, like, you know, that much room? Or, I mean, seriously, are you...
I've seen
you
right around our yard.
Yeah, but you didn't see me fall off the bike.
Nope, I didn't.
Magically. See this gap, guys? I stuck my finger in here, and I felt how deep it was. Okay? Now, I make sure I'm between the tread pattern, and I can feel it's... I have uniformly used the same finger. It's actually separate fingers. You have to make sure... If your fingers are different sizes, use the correct fingers. Okay? So I stuck the finger in the hole of the gap of the tread, and then I'm feeling about the gap there. And now I'm tightening this. Amazing, right? Some of these details are just like really cherry on the top because I think I've spent half as long building this bike just because of the mud flap.
Yeah.
Okay, camera crew's gonna move to the other side because she's just like, she wants to get every shot, every angle. I do like that this thing spins like all the way around. That's kind of nice. Not all e-bikes do that, by the way. Some of them are like blocked for some weird reason. Just to make life difficult on Brian Phillips RC. They're like, oh, Brian Phillips RC? Yeah, screw that guy. Give him extra screws. That's exactly what. They're like, who agreed to send them a bike? I'm like, I want to fire that guy right now. Just kidding. They're going to sell millions of these. Millions and millions of them. They're going to quickly forget about all the fun we poked at them. They'll be like, well, maybe we could have done that better. Honestly, it's a really nice bike. It's just, other than the fugly reflectors, which, you know, I don't think that's really their thing. I think it's a generic adaption.
Yeah, it seems to be a new
standard. And an ugly way of doing it. I do not like that design. That needs to be easier to do. Okay? Camera crew, come up here and show them this. You see all these different things? Those are all different sizes, folks. This is the size I need. How do you know it's the right size? Because I grabbed the one that was the same as it was before. Correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now watch this. I need to stick my fingers. Oh, geez.
You have to release that thingy.
What?
You have to loosen your nut.
Relax. That's a bolt. Relax, look. See how high we are? It's obviously wrong. You remember how I did one finger thickness?
Yeah.
Look how many finger thicknesses there are over here. What the heck is that crap? Okay, so I'm gonna release the thingy-ma-doohickey, which I knew, I just hadn't gotten to it yet. I had a reason, I had to stick my fingers in the doohickey.
Sure.
See, it's loose now, watch this. Down you go, oh, can't go any further down, evidently. Okay, well, I guess that's where it is. So do I need to go over to the other side and try to like torque it in there? I'm so confused. This is like one of the world's most complex installations. And you're seeing it for the first time on Brian Phillips RC. The manufacturer's like, oh,
finally. That's how that was supposed to go.
Yeah, we'll just go ahead and put that on now at the factory, except we'll scrap all the parts you used. Do it some way easier. This is ridiculous. There's like a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fasteners.
On each side.
Yep. And I'm like, but you welded a part and manufactured it into this thing. And yet you couldn't like come up with a bracket that has a bend in it? I don't know, whatever.
It's just fun to film.
You know what's really fun is when you work in manufacturing facilities for a living and you see the tedium that they go through to fix the smallest of obnoxious problems. And then you get these bikes and you're like, yeah, whatever, give them 17 extra screws. And you're like, really, seriously? Yes, seriously. Okay, look, there's 4 of these. Look, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4! Like that, like shaft. Shaft! That's what I was trying to do. Okay, so these small screws are going here. Now I gotta figure out from all these random ones, ooh, maybe that small one's the one I need. This one, see there's 4? Look at this, boom. Look at this, folks, this is gonna be amazing. It's gonna be amazing. It is the non-mount mount. Wrong.
I do not think you're supposed to put screws in there.
Wrong again. Wrong, camera crew. I know screws. Ask me anything about screws. I'm an expert in screws, except for these, evidently. Hey, wait, why do we not?
No, there's only one of those. That's the other thumb nut thing that goes on the...
That's the one that has texture.
Yeah.
Wrong.
Which is wrong. The same as
Megan,
this one.
Megan, that's sitting here. Somewhere else. See it?
The one that has texture?
Does that's that one?
Yes. Oh,
that's texture.
What was that I just said?
I was just saying how right you are. Okay. See? So I'm going to just... Oh, wrong. Dang it. So, you know what? You know what? Look at that. It's longer, isn't it? Nope, it goes in just fine. Did I just see lightning out there?
Maybe.
Improperly sized.
There's not supposed to be screws in.
Come back over here, please. Look. This one's the duplicate. This one's the nut that goes to this, okay? Shaft! This one's the redundant, this one's the redundant, this one's the redundancy. These are the redundancies. There's the other shaft and nut. Then there's the washer and 3 washers and then the 4th washer. So I do not know what the heck those go to, but I'm gonna tell you what. I think I've had about enough of this. I'm taking these out right now. It's just gonna be Paul's responsibility to keep me straight. I work for a guy named Paul. Paul, if you're watching this, you must be desperate for something to do.
Maybe he was really tired and he had insomnia.
We had somebody that told us that we helped them fall asleep, which is awesome. And if that's what you use, then just come here for all your sleeping needs.
Yeah.
All right, guys, and cutting boards, obviously.
Is it done?
Okay, I think Paul needs, oh, look, that other handle. That's what we've been looking for. Okay. Just. Yes! This feels like not super light or heavy. Feels about right. That's unusual. Paul's getting adjusted right now because I've had enough of it. Okay. If you guys want to build one of these yourself, follow the link in the video description below. I promise it's not as hard as we made it look, but you will have had the advantage of watching us do it. And that is actually somewhat helpful on a bicycle that is set up very weird and obnoxiously. And I'm just gonna say that thing looks sweet. I hope you can find an angle where the people at home can see, because that is gorgeous. And you know, it's funny because some of these e-bikes, you know, you don't think about it, but if you go to like Walmart or Target and you're getting a bike, they're not very big.
Yeah.
This thing is, look where the handlebar is. It's like way up here. I'm gonna adjust Paul. Paul, you're out of line. Sorry, Brian. I'll straighten up. No, I mean, I need you to go this way. Oh, dang it. Come on, Paul. Work with me, Paul. Okay. You guys see what I'm doing here? Yes.
Oh, you wanted it to go more forward?
Just a little bit. Huh. Just a little bit. Okay. Yep. Okay. Because you can only put Paul forward, not back. It's about the first third or so. Okay. Now, this is not like strength does it necessarily. I mean, you don't want it to come loose, but Paul is held into position and then under mechanical load between those knuckles or adjustment tines, poles, whatever. Now, everybody's gonna be like, it's not called a Paul, Brian. It's called a James. Just kidding. It's not gonna be that at all. Okay, so as you can see, we have all sorts of amazing things. You can actually mount a water bottle here. That's pretty sweet and actually very unusual. Mm-hmm. And back here, hold on, let's get, that's why I have gloves on. Beautiful. It's kind of, okay, that's gonna fall and hit my feet for sure. Okay, so I'm just gonna put the knives away because that's kind of dangerous. We already talked about, do you remember that?
I do.
So there are actually two adjustments on here in the back right here. And this would be allowed to tip back some. And I wonder if we need to adjust those so that this comes back a little bit. What do you think? Because now that it's sitting there, it's kind of got like a forward tilt to it.
But what are you going to put on there?
I don't know. I'm kind of like torn on whether or not I like it or hate it, because I'm thinking if you had a strap, you could strap to here and then you could strap to the other one and you could have like a chainsaw on there. So it is a cutting board.
Right.
Just covered in oil from a chainsaw.
Great.
Okay, so also talking about size, I'm 6'1". You'll see how it rode. If you watched the beginning of this video, you already know how that went. I do like the quick release on the chair. Looks like there's
a lot
of adjustments. Yeah, holy cow. So for those of you that are like 12 or 13 feet tall,
you're past them.
You'll be just right there.
You're not at the minimum insertion.
What?
You need to go in a little further.
Okay. So yeah, so you can adjust this to whatever height you need. It's got a pretty good range. And also I do like that it has a more standard insert for a chair. So if you decide you don't like the seat for a chair, like a recliner, you could put your recliner in there.
Yeah, that'd be good.
But seriously though, very detailed bike. Cannot wait to see it. Are we gonna turn it on right now? Let's turn it on.
Try.
I'm guessing there's a power button right here, so I'm just gonna press that button. I am covering the brake out of safety.
We need a key.
Oh, hello. Hello.
Oh, wow.
Brake lever error, because I was holding it. Whoa, that is a nice screen. Why don't you do this so that they can see?
Can't see.
See? Right there. Perfect, right? Okay, so there's buttons over here. There's a light. Whoa, the light's on, the light's off. Whoop, whoop. That's pretty good. Okay, so there should be a horn somewhere in here. The horn is probably, is there a horn? Whoa! Speed up, speed down, speed all the way up, all the way down. Time in minutes, why is that counting? Look at that, isn't that weird? Okay, and now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna lean like this. See this, watch this. It's gonna get crazy in here. Okay, so it's not.
You're in zero.
Oh, power assist 5. Whoa, 27.9, 28 miles per hour letting go. Look at that, no, keep the camera up there, hon. Look, go up higher. That's so sweet. I gotta love it. Man, that's like really well balanced too. Like, look at how this doesn't shake. Like, that is wiggling like crazy. Beep. Pretty cool.
Brake
lights. Ah, don't you know? Don't you know? Nice. Brakes. So you now, where's the turn signals? Are there turn signals? Because didn't they say something about turn signals in the manual, or was that just in my head?
No, I saw that, but I don't know where they would be. So you have an always on rear light, and then
oh, it's nice the intensity. Yep. Now hold on.
Okay.
When I turn off the light, what happens? Turn off the light. Oh, momentary push button.
Off, but now
and
brake.
And then the brake. So. Amazing.
Cool.
Oh, hold on. Turn signal.
No.
Turn signal. Okay, so it's not automatic. That's good. Because that'd be weird.
Yeah.
And you want to be able to juke people out if they're following you, of course. Okay, so we have power. There's is right here.
Is on.
Power's on the top. To show the people that are watching. Power's up here. Okay. Press and hold it, and it shuts off. Press it, and it turns on. You have to press and hold it for a moment. Okay, now it's on. Hello. Down goes nowhere. Sometimes down will walk. There's no walking happening.
Okay.
Okay, so throttle, nothing. Speed one. Okay, so there's definitely throttle. And then so on and so forth all the way. So basically the different speeds, if I go to speed one, I'm gonna hold my foot over the, that takes you to, it went past, what the heck? Oh, power assist has to do only with pedal assist. Assistance. Throttle is throttle, always full speed. So that's pretty cool. So we're in eco mode. Let's figure out how to change that right now. Do you remember how to change that camera crew by chance?
Nope. We'll have to read the manual.
We have to read the manual? That's
yeah.
Terrible. Let's just look at the manual right now.
It was towards the back. There's a chart.
Okay. Almost there, guys. This manual is super helpful. As you can tell, after we read it, we were super, like, we knew all the details. We are gonna show you how to plug in the battery in a minute. Okay, press up, down, and lights to enter the menu. Okay, press up, down, and lights. Okay, so ready? Up, down, and lights, right here. In the menu. Speed limit. Okay, that takes you out. The lights take you out. Press all three. Okay, the up arrow takes you up. The down arrow takes you down. The power button, oh wait, maybe it's this horn. Nope, the power button, nope, the power button. Oh, look at that, 20. What? Are you serious, La? What?
I'm sure it's not gonna
actually
do that.
If that is true, I love this bike more than I even knew. Hit power to go back, power assist gear. Ah, oh, I hit back. Okay, we are lifting the wheel. We are in power assist 5. Okay, I'll take it. Well, we inadvertently told you how to make this faster. Oops.
Sorry.
We're gonna test and see if it is. But anyway, okay, going back into menu. That's pretty much what you wanted to see anyway. Between that and mounting the
vendor.
Then, yeah, there you go. Okay, so power takes you in. Okay, power assist gear. Oh, they have three. I'm setting that for sure. Voltage level. What? 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 What is this thing? I thought it was
36.
Hold on a second now. Hold on now.
I don't know if it tells you in the manual. Oh, by the way, this thing times out after a short time.
Okay, we'll just go back in. I'm sorry, guys. Okay. Voltage. Well, I guess that's
well,
where...
I think I would, yeah, leave it.
Wheel diameter. 29. I guess that's right. Taco magnets. Okay. Rating modes. Pedal and motor. Pedal only. Okay, we'll keep both.
Intensity settings, 3 of 5. Ooh, 5. Factory reset. Yeah, right. No. No thanks. Okay, so there you have it first from Brian Phillips RC. We showed you 61 miles an hour. I will believe it when I see it. And also, I must say, I don't understand. So I hit light to exit and come back out. Light turns on, turns off. You just momentarily press it. And then horn, if you press and hold it, it's really annoying. But also, we have brakes. We have brake lights. We have a cutting board if you need to stop for a picnic. We have reflective tires and ugly reflectors on the wheels. What more could you possibly want? This is actually a pretty sweet bike.
It is.
So let's talk about charging quick. I'm gonna turn off the light. I am just gonna power it down. It's not actually probably unsafe, but we'll just show you. Okay, power it off. All right, so we have to stick this thing in the other thing. So I'm just gonna stick this thing into that thing, except it won't reach. So I'm gonna stick this thing into that thing because it's a closer reach and you'll see there's a green light. The green light indicates that the charger's on, but it's not plugged in. Then I probably don't need to crawl on the ground, but I'm gonna crawl on the ground because it shows more effort or something. Ah, look, and it has switched to red, which means it's forcing juice into the bike. Now, I don't understand what this thing is.
Wasn't there some...
Oh, it's a different type of power connector or something.
Wait, at the beginning of the manual.
It said, yeah, like connect the thing to the doohickey.
Plug the power cord.
I know what the key is for.
Oh, what? I know what that thing is. They offer an inverter that's like an optional power inverter thing. I wonder if that's what
so
that's
you can
for.
Like hook it up to your house and like run
yeah,
the air conditioner
for solar.
I'm just kidding.
So am I. But they do offer an inverter.
I just unplugged that. So let's watch this. Does the battery fall? No, it doesn't. I wiggled it both ways. Key in, turn the key. Guess what happens? Now wiggle and there she blows.
Nice.
That is like the easiest release ever.
Yeah, it is.
All right, this says, this one's 19.6 amp hours, 924 watt hours. Good Lord, they're like down to the milliwatt. 47.19 volts DC. This is a lithium ion battery pack. And yes, you can plug in your inverter as well to this. And then you're not supposed to lick these. Megan was giving you bad advice.
Don't lick those, okay.
Yep, so this is pretty sweet. And look, there's a power button. Ooh, it dances until it's ready to tell you what you want to know. Okay?
Okay.
So then this clippy doohickey, it's screwed from the inside so it doesn't move.
And then you can use your regular charger down there where your thumb is if you take it out, right?
Stick it in the hole. Okay? And by the way, that's a pass-through, isn't it? Yes, it is. You see my finger?
Okay. Yeah.
So now you know all the bells and whistles. Here, turn on the light and hand that to me. I'll show you inside the cavity.
Ooh.
Wowzers. Look at that. We've got a clip doohickey. Ooh, fancy. There it is, folks. Okay. All right. So we've probably showed most of the things that most of you want to see. And some of those things we can't show.
If there's more you need to see.
Watch. Click. It's in. Pull the key out. You don't need the key in. That just keeps your battery from falling out. I love it,
that's
actually.
That's really nice.
Because, you know, to be honest with you, we have a lot of bikes where you have to have the key in to run it. And let's just be honest, guys. If somebody wants to steal your bike, they're going to walk up to it like this and they're going to pick it up. They're going to put it in the trunk and they're going to drive away.
Yeah.
Or they might cut the light pole down and take the light pole too.
Or they'll just get on it and ride it
away.
Well,
and people put locks around their bikes sometimes. So we actually got a lock on the first bike we got, which is a Fido. And that bike was very small. It
yeah,
was
our
like.
Daughter rides it.
Yeah, she's the only one that fits on it basically. But I rode it down the ditch and I broke the seat off of the battery that was what held the seat up.
And then it was just a shaft.
And I was like, in slow motion, but I lived, barely. Okay, as you can tell, how could this guy ever get hurt? This thing looks sweet though. It's definitely a different looking bike. This thing can be adjusted forward and backward, and there are 6 screws that will allow you to take the cutting board off for cleaning in the dishwasher.
Not dishwasher safe. Do not put that in your dishwasher.
Okay. And then, yes, the shifter is going to go up and down with trigger pulls like this. Okay. Pretty simple stuff. And we have a hub drive motor. But it is interesting because the inverter, like, thing up here, there's like this heat sink looking sides on it. Do you want to know why there's a heat sink looking side on it?
Probably because the battery gets hot.
That's not the battery.
Well, it's close to the battery.
That's not the battery though. Why?
I don't know.
Answer the question. Do you know why?
No.
That is where all the magic happens. It's where the electricity is converted to other types of electricity and it turns the motor. And there are actually very hot components when running. So in case you didn't already know that. I gotta say, it's easy to turn on, it's easy to turn off. And if it's easy to turn on, I like it. What? Giving me that look. So I also think that these are gonna be a double-edged sword. I'm not sure if I like them yet, but I do like that they give you this like padding, but I don't know if I'd rather just like have more leather. I'm not sure, it depends on if your hand sweats and it's gross.
Yeah.
I haven't made up my mind if I like that. Now that can be changed too, by the way, very easy. Two screws, comes off, this slides off. Okay, well, maybe two more screws. And then also, this is kind of loose, like I might tighten that. Not a big deal either way. And then obviously, Paul's gonna be a problem child. I just hope he doesn't give me any problems like coming undone while I'm riding him.
Yeah.
It just came across really bad. But the adjustment for the lean of the handlebar camera crew.
I didn't say anything.
I know, but I could tell what you were thinking because I said it. Okay, so there you have it, guys. You've already seen me ride it. I'm sure I rode it in a completely inappropriate environment. You know what? This kind of reminds me of like, it reminds me of like an on-road bike because it's so dang big. The fat tires don't even look like fat tires. They look like regular tires. Did you get that feeling too? Or is that just in my head? And then also, I'll be riding it so you'll see me on, but I can tell that the mounting is gonna be better on this than some that we've seen. I'm sort of reluctant to mount it because of where the adapter's sitting. But I think this thing is gonna fit me better. And I really like that there's a place here to have a drink holder. It's amazing how many e-bikes are like, this person doesn't need to drink.
Well, you're not working, you're just sitting there. It's like driving the car.
Well, you can.
Now you can make your lunch, so you definitely need a spot for your drink.
That's right. And very disappointed about the scratch, but honestly, I don't really care. In fact, let's show the people how I'm gonna fix it. Let's show them the way I'll fix it. I'm gonna fix it with two steps. Step one would be, I could use electrical tape, or step two, I could get a fatty out. What? Fatty marker. And watch this, watch this disappear right before your very eyes. We should do a short about that, like fixing bikes.
My only concern is I want it to peel more.
No, it will eventually. And who cares? It's not that big a deal. If you're worried about that, then you shouldn't buy things from China. I'm just gonna say that seriously because we got a free Frisbee.
True.
That's pretty awesome. The kids are gonna love that.
They are.
Okay, so let's talk about positives and negatives of this machine. I think the positives are there is a cat trying to climb our window.
Well, you didn't let her in the back door, so.
Okay, so positives, it's super easy assembly.
Only takes an hour and I don't know how long the other video was.
Well, all I'm gonna say is this bike actually feels like it's gonna be stout. It feels like it's gonna be strong, but, oh God, it's heavy. Yeah, these things are heavy. They're always heavy, but let's just say this. If it rides half as good as it looks, I think it's gonna be a great fit for me because I am like almost 300 pounds dressed. I mean, naked, it's like, I'm like 260. My clothes are just really heavy. How did she get all the way over here? She's all the way over here. She was just there. I wonder if that's another cat. So if you hear about cats that have eaten a family, it was us, obviously. Yeah. But we then subsequently published the video after we were like dying from cat attack. There was a cat, there was something, well, close by. I shouldn't talk about that because I don't know all the details, but it was like a mountain lion or something.
And that happens.
Oh wait, was it bobcat? Bobcat there, and their kitten cats.
Yeah, there were bobcats around here.
So that was pretty cool the other day. So I mean, everybody gets all excited like, oh, they're so cute. And then they're like eating somebody and they're like, oh, why do we leave them here? We're off topic here.
Yes.
This thing looks cool. I'm thinking that if you guys have enjoyed this video, even in the slightest, please smash the like button. It will help us. We do long format here on Brian Phillips RC on YouTube, and long format is a dying art. If you want to call this art, I'll take it. What I would suggest is if you decide to buy an e-bike, make sure you get the bike that's the right size for you. I'm 6'1", 6'1½", 6'3" if I'm buying life insurance. And I am about like probably 285, something like that. I've been lighter in my life, like before I eat a lot of food and stuff like that. And that's fine. That's why I have all these workout bikes, so I can go work out with the throttle. But seriously, I do have to actually help pedal these up our hills because we do have a pretty extreme gradient on our property, which will help to showcase the qualities of this bike. And I do like the tires. It's kind of like an off-road style tire. Mm-hmm. I don't usually like fat tires any better on gravel. I thought it would be like some like huge improvement. It is a big improvement compared to a thin tire, but it's still like, to me, I feel like insecure on them. And these are 4-inchers. Mm-hmm. We have done as big as 4.8 tires, but that particular bike, we had issues with a number of different small things, but it was a really nice bike too. It was one of the more powerful bikes we have. Also, we never changed the mode, did we? Because there's an eco mode. How do you switch out of eco mode?
Yeah, that's what we were
Guys, I'm sorry. I showed you how to speed it up, but I never talked about the eco mode. We might need to figure that out real quick. We'll come right back with that answer. All right, so we just realized that the menu that we see in this picture is different than the menu that we had access to. So we're gonna try to get into it right now. I'm sorry, folks, we try to do this right. I press up, down, and light at the same time. And it comes up with speed limit.
See, that says technical settings. That says functional settings.
Riding modes, intensity setting, factory reset. That is so weird. Going up, going out, can I hit back? 61, oops, back is this. Okay, I'm gonna just use up and down. There's functional settings. Oh. Up and down and light takes you into the other setting. Okay, so brightness is gonna be level 1, level 2, level 3. Now I'm gonna tell you, when this is really bright, it's annoying when it's a dark, okay? So I'm gonna accept that with the light. Okay, so I'm gonna hit power to accept. Then unit, this is where you can choose between kilometers an hour and miles per hour. Startup mode. Yes, free and safe mode. Safe mode means you have to pedal. You have to pedal to actually start the motor, okay? I'm gonna keep it in free mode because I'm furry in America. Trip reset. Yes, boom. Oh yeah, see the time?
But we still don't know the eco.
Okay, so let's press up and hold it. Nothing changed. Let's press down and hold it. Nothing. Is this a touchscreen? No. That's a light. Oh, that's a horn. There's a power button. I could press and hold the power button.
Hey, if you go off of pedal assist, the eco doesn't go away, does it?
No. Ever? And I set it to 3 speeds, remember, guys? Mm-hmm. So that doesn't change the overall speed. It just changes the pedal assist. Feels more like Johnny on the spot when you're plugged into the wall. So if you want to go faster, plug it into the wall. Okay, so all joking aside, I don't know how to change it. So maybe I'm going to press just up and see what happens. I haven't seen anything. Now I'm going to press down and see if anything changes. Ooh, crappers. That was the walk mode.
Oh.
It almost spilled my cat food. Okay, so I'm at speed level 3.
What did you do?
I press and hold the down button, but evidently you have to be in liberty. That takes a long time. Well, I'm in speed level 3. Or that's pedal assist level 3. All right, well, now we know that. I tried it, but I didn't try it long enough, evidently. Okay, so the only thing I haven't done is pressed up and light, and then I'll try down and light. Okay, I haven't seen anything. Now, down and light, it may jump, so watch your feet.
What the heck just happened? It changed the display. Do you see that?
Yes.
That's weird. Okay, so does this still work? It does. Brakes. Okay, so now, up or down in light. It's gonna change back at some point, I'm sure.
Maybe you have to push up and light now to go back to that other
thing. Oh, okay, up and light. Okay, good idea, up and light. So guys, these are the sort of things that we try to do on the channel, and some others don't. We're not trying to beat anybody else up, but is that color orbulating between yellow and green?
Orbulating? I don't know, but my battery's gonna die.
Oh crap, really?
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't know how to get back, so I'm gonna press power and turn it off. Press and hold power, it shuts off. Press the power, see if it turns back on to the normal mode. Hello, nice to see you again. Oh, it goes back to the normal mode.
Okay.
So that's evidently how you switch something. So I don't know how to switch it. I'm trying to figure it out. Press and hold down and light to enter interface 2. Press light to exit, okay? So light alone.
Okay.
The speed shows the current speed, trip, eco, okay, power when riding at higher speeds, number 9. Power button, press and hold power. Up, increase power assist, light. Press and hold down to enter standard ride. There we go. Press and hold down. Look. Down. Look. Nope, that's standard ride. With power assist 0, remember it walks, so be careful. All right, so that definitely goes forward. Press and hold light to turn on rear light and headlight. Standard ride, press and hold down to ride to set of 6 kilometers. That's totally wrong. Custom ride, press and hold down while riding to set current speed as riding. Oh, press and hold down for cruise control.
Oh.
I do not know how to switch. Speed shows current speed. Eco when riding at lower speeds, power when riding at... Okay, hold on.
So it's automatic.
Let's go to power 3. Power.
Okay. So you can't change that on your
No, phone. It's not a setting. Okay. Which is an unusual way to display it.
Yeah.
Okay. So just to be clear, all those things we just said are what you can do with the buttons. And I would just spend some time and study our video and watch it over and over again and smash the like button every time from different devices, obviously.
Yes.
And then when you're ready to buy a second one for your spouse or your friend, then just follow the link in the video description below. You'll help support us. This was a long one. Sorry it's so long and boring and tedious, but we know you loved it or you wouldn't be watching right now. So thanks for being part of our little RC family, because this is obviously not RC. So anyway, I'm just kind of striking out today, aren't I?
Yeah.
So guys, we do have RC content coming very soon, and I think you're going to be very thrilled to see it. And we're excited to have you with us here on Brian Phillips RC. This bike should be sweet. I hope you enjoyed the ride along at the beginning. And we do enjoy doing these things for you, even though sometimes it looks like we're tediously building bikes on Friday night before we get our pizza after 11 o'clock at night.
Time to go.
It is actually something we like to do, which seems kind of strange.
Build bikes?
Build no. bikes.
Eat pizza.
No, we like to ride bikes.
Yes.
We don't like to build them.
And
truth is, like with airplanes and stuff, we build them because we want to try to provide a little bit of service to you and not just say, hey, buy it from our links and give us money and things. That's not what we're all about here. We're trying to actually provide a service. There's some people that do need help with this stuff. And so hopefully you found a little bit of help. And if you didn't find help, then I'm not sure we watched it, but we appreciate you doing it. So anyway, guys, this bike is kind of cool. I think it's probably gonna be one of the nicer bikes for me.
Yeah, I think so.
I'm big and I need a big bike. And so when they're big and they're comfortable and they hold together and they have big brakes, that's what I need.
And sometimes they're big, but then like the seat and the handlebars are not at an appropriate
position.
Height different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like you're sitting,
this
like
one
you're
looks
leaning forward.
Like you're going right. to look normal.
I mean, but it does have the cutting board, which is a little bit strange. And honestly, I could see somebody taking this and just loving that color. And I could see somebody hating the color and like painting it black.
I think there's other options. Like there's baskets.
Yeah.
And there's different there things that they give out at different
But they
times.
Give you strap points on this, which they don't
right.
have on many of them. And that's something that's been a big complaint of mine on the different basket choices, is because, like, I mean, the basket is probably the most productive way to do it. But if I want to bring a chainsaw out and cut a tree down, we have thousands of thousands and thousands of trees on our property. We don't cut trees down just for fun. We love trees.
But the thing is, in fact, it's hurting our souls because we're going to have to lose some trees to put this pond in. Which, by the way, if you don't know, we're putting a pond in, if God permits, and there are many, many, many things coming from God.
County.
Lightning bolts. He's like, no, super you. But we're working on it.
Battery. I'm just telling the story another day.
All right, guys. So we'll tell you that story another day. This does look cool. We appreciate you watching. These are tediously long, and we appreciate you staying for the whole thing, all four of you. Come back for more. And seriously, we do have more. And when I say more, I don't mean necessarily just this, but we have more planes, and there's tons of them right around the corner here on Brian Phillips RC. We're here to help serve you and help you sort through the millions of different choices online. And by the way, the bikes, we have probably 4 to 10 companies that hit us every week asking us to do bikes. And we kind of winnow it down to like a couple a month or maybe once a month during the winter, because a lot of people are riding bikes during the winter.
Yeah, definitely.
So guys, seriously, I know you don't believe me when I say that, but it is actually true. We tell the truth on this channel. We try to show the bad things and the good things. This is a really nice bike. It's just kind of a pain to build, but they're always a pain, to be honest. This had really good packaging. It did actually go together pretty good. And if you weren't filming it, it would be no big deal.
Yeah.
So that's all you got. Thanks for watching, guys. We appreciate you. Come back for more. Oh, and then don't forget, if you want to support us, we have YouTube memberships, YouTube Super Thanks. That's one-time gifts on YouTube, or monthly support for members. And then we have Patreon membership, which is through a third-party Patreon. And that also gives you some like sort of pseudo access to us for comments if you need a little quicker responses. But we don't list that because you'd have to pay value-added tax if you're overseas. And then we also have Patreon and PayPal. PayPal. That's one-time gifts. And just remember, friends and family, it's available. It saves on fees for us. And then also, it's not like you're going to return it. So, because there's not, I mean, the service has already been provided. And then also, we want to just let you know, if you're in Europe, for years and years and years, we were saying, hey, you can't support us on, you know, if you're over in Europe. Well, if you're in Europe, you can support us. Horizon Hobby links are listed on Brian Phillips RC and also in the links down below. So you can go to Horizon Hobbies EU store. And then we also have Canadian store for FMS and some other manufacturers. So definitely check that out. If you guys are in a different region, you're not sure if the shipping works for you, we do work with RC Going and Banggood as well. So some of these bikes we realize are going to be North American based or China based or Asian based, or even we never really know until you guys start ordering. But generally speaking, they're going to be a US based thing. So if you're in New Zealand or if you're in Australia, I don't know what to tell you. You're going to have to talk to your politicians and see if they can change some of the tariffs, because it's very expensive to get lipos out there. And I think that's part of the reason why you have so much trouble getting airplanes and things like this, because we looked into it and it's like really complicated. So anyway, that's all we got for you. I know it was kind of a blip at the end of actual useful information, but that's why we do it here on Brian Phillips RC. If you haven't seen one before, just stay tuned. We have thousands of videos. Check it out, brianphillipsrc.com. Check for coupon codes before you buy, and then you can help yourself save a few bucks and also help pat us on the back by following the links. That's all we got. Come back for more.